Absolutely, and there's no doubt about it. And Coach Altman, obviously, you know, he said the Jays did some good things, especially in that second half. It was just the initial. He was very disappointed in the way his team came out because they knew the Shockers were going to come out on fire and be all pumped up because everybody was bringing up the Valley Tournament, 1.9 seconds, that whole deal. It was in the morning paper in Wichita last Saturday morning, and the Jays simply weren't ready for that.
And that's what I can guarantee you. Greg Marshall's telling the Wichita State Shockers, Creighton's going to come out and be ready to play, so they need to make Greg Marshall's statements probably true with coming out and be ready to play. Have a lot of energy, a lot of emotion, a lot of passion. Again, white out here at Quest Center Omaha. It's going to be a great crowd. No reason to not come out. Let it all hang out and play your heart out for the minutes that you are given. On top of that, Creighton's going to have to make some shots. They're going to have to find a way to put the ball in the basket. It's what they haven't been doing. It's what they've been struggling with, and it's what they didn't do at Wichita State. They just couldn't buy a basket. And Creighton's got good three-point shooters. They got good offensive scores. Those guys got to come. They got to come to the party and score.
One of the guys that struggled in the last couple of games, despite the Jays going 1-1, freshman Ethan Brogy, after knocking down three threes in the win against Drake, Ethan is now 2-for-9 in the last two games. He was 1-for-4 against Wichita a week ago and 1-for-5 against SIU on Wednesday. And it's not because he's not getting open looks. Dana Altman runs sets for Ethan Brogy to give him that classic baseline look that over the years all the Blue Jay wing players have been able to knock down. And Ethan has traditionally and historically this season been knocking him down. He will be a big key for me this afternoon because they're going to get him in and they're going to try to run those same plays for him. And, you know, when he knocks down threes, the crowd gets fired up.
Well, Creighton needs somebody to consistently knock down a perimeter jump shot to open up driving lanes for P. Allen Stinnett, for Justin Carter,
for Darryl Ashford.
And then it'll also give Kenny Lawson room to operate on the block. That in many estimations, offensively, is my number one priority. Somebody has to emerge as that dead-eye knockdown three-point shooter that the defense has to honor, and my number one candidate for that position or that role would be Ethan Brogy.
He's a natural, and also at his size, at 6'7", 6'8", he really creates a lot of mismatch problems. When you talk about Kenny Lawson, Nick, Kenny came back in that second half against Wichita State, stuck with it, and actually ended up with a pretty good game. 15 points and 6 boards. And, I mean, really, when you look at it, Kenny, along with Antoine, who finished with 10 points, Antoine's going to be big, too. Well, we'll get to him in a second. Kenny Lawson, his confidence that he's gained makes him a tough matchup now for any post player in the Valley. And I'll be interested to see if Greg Marshall even chooses to double him at all, because a lot of teams have been doubling him. And I feel that Marshall feels comfortable enough with Durley, with Flair, with those big guys, with Stutz, that they won't bother to double him. And I think Kenny could have a big day.
Yeah, I agree. I think Greg Marshall is going to make Kenny Lawson score and make him beat you early, and then he'll adjust. But I think he feels confident in Durley and Blair and those guys to handle him one-on-one. And if they do that, that's where Kenny Lawson has to get where he wants to get to on the floor. Post up, close to the basket, good proximity to the goal, and then play to your strengths. Don't fade away. Go to that right-hand jump shot, and try and get to the line. Shot fake, jump into the guys. I think both Durley and Blair are susceptible to shot fakes, and you can jump into them and get to the line.
All right, we're going to take another break. When we come back, we'll take a look at other games around the Valley this afternoon. This is the American National Bank pregame show on Big Sports 590.
Free safeties in football. Free throws in basketball. Free passes to first base in baseball. At U.S. Cellular, we're happy to report we also have something that's free. When you get one of our plans, you get free incoming calls, texts, and pics with it. So nearly half the time you spend on your phone is free. Save money with free incoming calls, texts, and pics from anyone at any time. Only from U.S. Cellular.
See store for details.
U.S. Cellular. Believe in something better.
Stay on top of your game with the primary care physicians and specialists of Creighton Medical Associates. They'll give it all they've got to ensure the finest medical care for you and your family, from newborns to senior citizens. Stick with the winning team of Creighton Medical Associates, because good health is the right play of the game. Visit www.findyourphysician for a Creighton Medical Associates physician right for you and your family.
Service in the Marriott tradition. That's what you'll find at the Omaha Downtown Courtyard by Marriott. This fully restored historic building offers its guests 181 spacious rooms, suites, and spas, an indoor pool, whirlpool, and exercise room with a breakfast buffet available daily. Call today and ask about the special Creighton weekend rate based on availability. The Omaha Downtown Courtyard by Marriott, 101 South 10th. Call 346-2200 today.
When you're looking for the best deal on a new Chevrolet, shop the Chevy Guy. When you want to shop online, shop thechevyguy.com. The largest Silverado selection in the city. Five-star service after the sale. Only at Southwest Iowa's largest Chevy dealer. The Chevy Guy. Classic Chevrolet in Council Bluffs. Take the I-80 Lake Manawa exit. Look for the big yellow sign and get ready to save.
And we're back at Quest Center, Omaha. T. Scott Maher, Nick Paul here with you, just minutes away from the opening tip. Let's take a look at the other games around the Valley, brought to you by the State Farm MVC Men's Championship. That's coming up March 4th through the 7th. It's the 20th anniversary of Arch Madness, and you can watch the Jays compete at Scott Trade Center. Get your tickets for Arch Madness online at Ticketmaster.com, or you can call St. Louis 314-241-1888. Other games around the Valley this afternoon. You've got Southern Illinois at Evansville. I like the Salukis' chances there. Missouri State at Bradley, an interesting game. We'll see how the Bears fare in Peoria. And Indiana State will try to go up to Cedar Falls and deal Northern Iowa, their first conference loss of the season. Looking at the standings, it's all Northern and Wichita State right now. Northern unbeaten in conference play at 6-0. Shockers right behind at 4-5-1. Illinois State right behind them at 4-2. And then you got the Pack at 3-3. Missouri State, Indiana State, and Creighton. We're going to take our final break. We'll come back. Starting lineups, opening tip, coming up next on Big Sports 590.
Building a winning tradition takes time. It starts with an attitude that will accept nothing less than excellence. The winning attitude eventually becomes a winning tradition. Hi, this is Coach Dane Aul. The Inn at Okoboji has been a vacation and business destination for over 100 years. It's become a proud Midwest tradition. I've enjoyed taking my family there, and I think you will too. For a carefree getaway or a corporate outing, call the Inn Resort and Conference Center at Lake Okoboji at 877-BOGIE-FUN.
It's the dead of winter now, which means baseball season is already right around the corner. Hi, I'm Brad Perot with UBA. Want to get an edge on your competition? UBA can help you do exactly that with our 55,000 square foot indoor training facility where it's always baseball weather. In addition to our facility, our staff of instructors knows exactly how to help you improve. Check out our new website to see upcoming events, which are now available to sign up for online. Lessons and rental time are also available. Just go to ubanebraska.com or call 935-1-UBA.
Free safeties in football, free throws in basketball, free passes to first base in baseball. At U.S. Cellular, we're happy to report we also have something that's free. When you get one of our plans, you get free incoming calls, texts, and pics with it. So nearly half the time you spend on your phone is free. Save money with free incoming calls, texts, and pics from anyone at any time. Only from U.S. Cellular.
See store for details.
U.S. Cellular. Believe in something better.
There's nothing like Creighton basketball at home. The atmosphere is electric, and the Valley is more competitive than ever. That's why DJ's Dugout salutes all the Blue Jay fans that help make the Quest Center Omaha one of the most difficult places to play in the country. For opposing teams, be sure to catch all available hard-to-find Creighton TV and webcast away games at DJ's Dugout at 114th and Dodge, and the brand spanking new DJ's Dugout at 23rd and Cornhusker Road in Bellevue. So, dig in at the Dugout, and go Blue Jays!
Welcome back to Quest Center Omaha, everybody. It's time now for your starting lineups, brought to you by DJ's Dugout. Dig in at the Dugout. We'll start with the visiting Shockers. They are 16-2 overall, 5-1 in the Valley, and coached by Greg Marshall in his third season with the Shockers. In the backcourt at the point, number three, Clevin Hanna, a 5'11 senior out of Holly Springs, Mississippi. Hanna averaging 12 points, 3 rebounds, and nearly 5 assists per game. One of three Shockers in double-digit average. Also in the backcourt, number 23, 6'4 sophomore Toure Murray out of Houston, Texas. Murray also averaging double figures, 13 points and 5 rebounds a game. At the forwards, number 0, Aaron Ellis, a 6'6 junior out of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Ellis averaging 4 points and 3 rebounds a game. And he is joined by Graham Hatch, a 6'4 junior out of Mesa, Arizona. Number 14, Hatch, averaging 9 points and 3 rebounds a game. Down low, Pittsburgh, Texas native, number 31, JT Durley, averaging 11 points and 4 rebounds a game. Now the starting lineups for your Creighton Blue Jays. They are 8-9 on the season, 3-3 in Valley play, and they are coached by the dean of the Missouri Valley Conference, Dana Altman. In his 16th season at Creighton, his assistants, Darren DeVries, Brian Fish, and Todd Eisner. At the point, number 30, 6-foot sophomore Antoine Young out of Bellevue, Nebraska. Antoine averaging 5 points, 1 rebound, and 3 assists per game. He is joined in the backcourt by junior college transfer Darrell Ashford. Number 24, a 6'4 junior out of Houston, Texas. Ashford averaging 8 points and 3 rebounds a game. He gets the nod again this afternoon. On the wings, Justin Carter, number 1 out of Gaithersburg, Maryland. 6'4 senior averaging 9 points, 5 rebounds a game. He set the tone right out of the gate against Southern Illinois on Wednesday. Also at the forward, number 32, Casey Harriman, the 6'5 junior out of Ida Grove, Iowa. The Iowa native averaging just 2 points and 2 rebounds, but he brings toughness and leadership to the floor. Down low, we've talked about him, number 25, Kenny Lawson, junior, 6'9 junior out of Oceanside, California, leading the team in scoring and rebounding. The big fella averaging 12 points and 7 rebounds a game. Starting lineups brought to you by DJ's Dugout. Dig in at the dugout. Officials today, Steve Olson, David Hall, and Terry Weimer. Great crowd on hand this afternoon. As of an hour before tip, there were only about 700 tickets remaining available out there. So those walk-ups could probably still get there. But a great crowd on hand, as you talked about, the whiteout, Nick. Looks great on national television. And just an electric atmosphere. You know, after the SIU game, I heard a lot of people, more than one, honestly, talking about the atmosphere was better than any game all year long here, and really some of the best ever at Quest Center.
Well, yeah, and I think Coach Altman said it best after the game when he said it felt like a Creighton game. And I think there's just been something missing, whether it's been some energy from the fans or whether it's been some passion from the Blue Jays. Sometimes it's one and the same. And I think they found it on Wednesday. And I just looking at the crowd and just feeling the emotion and energy in the building right now, I expect another exciting basketball game this afternoon. Something that should be noted is basket that Wichita State will be going towards their goal in the right. First half, rim got jarred loose during warm-ups, and it is pretty flimsy, and they've been having to tighten it up, but it keeps getting loosened back up. So we'll keep an eye on that. Creighton will be going that way in the second half, but little things like that, you never know.
Oh, absolutely.
What could make a difference?
Yep, absolutely. They were working on that. Actually, Stan Venis, director of operations here at Quest Center, along with some Blue Jays staff, were working on that during the warm-ups. I think they caught it on camera. And
my attention immediately.
Yeah, well,
when I walked in, rim was just flopping everywhere.
It's very loose. And they said that they tighten it and then it loosens up again so that you may see them at halftime go back out and do it again. Try to tighten it back up. All right, just about set to go here. Aaron Ellis in the center circle. He'll be jumping it up against Kenny Lawson. And again, Ellis listed at 6'6".
That's not
but
right.
he does the duties for Greg Marshall despite having 6'7", JT Durley, 6'8", Gabe Blair, Garrett Stutz at 7 foot. That just tells you how athletic Aaron Ellis is. All right, ready to go here. Television, of course, dictating, and we are ready to go. Jays in their home whites, Shockers in the black, and Lawson controls the rebound. Ashford gives it up to Antoine Young. We're in business. Jays moving left to right. High post to Kenny Lawson. Fires it out of the wing to Carter. Left side now to Ashford. Bounces it to Casey Harriman, guarded by Hatch. On the baseline is Justin Carter. He is trying to back in on Ellis. Gives up to Ashford. Jump shot on the way, challenged. And again, that long arm, but there's Carter with a rebound. Offensive a rebound and a foul immediately as Carter goes right up with it and draws the contact.
Yeah, set play to post up Justin Carter, and then Casey Harriman penned in for Darrell Ashford, who got a jump shot. You said it, the length bothered him, but Justin Carter, his activity has been tremendous for the last handful of games. Again, on the offensive glass, it goes right back up through the contact. Good possession from Justin.
Carter, 58% on the season from the line, but Wednesday, he was money, 6 for 6, and knocks down that first one. I like that. That sets a tone early, Nick.
And Justin Carter, again, they were led by two seniors on Wednesday. Chad Millard sparked the Jays off the bench. Justin was the leading scorer, 19 points, did a really good job. Sometimes you're only as good as your seniors.
Carter's second free throw out of his hands, and it is good. Rattle down, Jays on the board. Harriman at the point of the press. Hatch looks to get it in, does get it in. Clevin Hanna guarded by Antoine Young. This is a good matchup. The senior guarded by the sophomore. Hannah up the right side, fires it up on the wing. Out to Ellis on the near wing again. Hannah looking down on the block. Left side is Durley. Double team. Back outside. Tyree Murray out of the wing hatch. 13 on the shot clock. Cutting inside, Tyree Murray. That ball knocked away, intended for Murray, knocked away by Darryl Ashford.
Good deflection.
11 on the shot clock.
Being a 2-3 zone now. Got to communicate where Graham Hatch is.
Hannah to inbound right side of the Shocker hoop. Setting picks. They find Murray. Murray, pump fake. Got Antoine Young in the air. Murray driving inside. Wild shot, no good. Trying to keep a handle on that is Harriman. Up, Young. Running is Carter. Pulls up on the wing, slips. Around the arc they go. Harriman to Ashford. Darryl on the move. Top of the key, Carter. Right wing Ashford, right wing Harriman. Looking inside to Lawson. There's a bounce pass, right block. Kinney, double team. Now Kinney backing in. Again, double team. Kicks out Carter. Carter down inside. Back out Antoine Young, 10 on the shot clock. Lawson left block. Hannah showing double team. Top of the key. Antoine Young, three, weak, no good. Knocked out of bounds by the Shockers, and the Jays catch a break.
Well, right now what they're doing is Clevin Hanna's guarding Antoine Young, and they're having him just kind of sit in the paint and almost dig all the time off of Antoine Young when the ball goes into Kenny Lawson. Twan's going to have to knock down that shot. That three-point shot's going to be there.
Yep. All right, so the inbound near side front court, Ashford to Young. Young now looking for help, and he finally finds Lawson high post, who finds Ashford high wing right side. Back over to Antoine Young, guarded by Clevin Hanna. Fresh 35, top of the key is Ashford, driving down left side. Darryl Ashford misses the layup. They let him go when Ashford missed it with the left hand. On the run, Toure Murray slides inside, right past Antoine Young, lays it up and down.
We're Antoine
tied at 2-2.
Set to take a charge there, T. Scott, and Murray just slid right by him.
Darryl Ashford on the move again, top of the key, Harriman, right wing Carter. Working on Aaron Ellis, long at 6'6". It's like he's got arms of a 7-footer. Ashford over to Carter, down inside, let him go, off the glass, no good. Lawson controls, Lawson inside, jump ball as Kenny Lawson is tied up by a Shocker, and it'll go Shocker's way.
Wichita State basketball.
Good job by Kenny Lawson, he kind of tipped it to himself, then got it, but then again, the length and strength of Wichita State ties him up, creates a jump ball.
So Hannah will bring it up for the Shockers, just a couple of minutes in here, we're tied at twos. Hannah walks the ball on the timeline, now picks up steam. Runs Young through a screen set by Ellis. Top of the key is Tyree Murray. Shockers 37% from downtown, 46 from the field. Hatch driving inside. Ball rejected by Lawson, but retrieved by Hatch. Out of the wing, Hannah. He'll rise up for a three and the way, and it's good. Nothing but nylon. Clevin Hannah. Second opportunity. 5-2. Antoine Young driving inside. Making Justin Carter. Misses the layup, but he drew the contact as Carter drove hard from the left side and drew the foul. JT Durley called for his first personal.
And I like Justin Carter's aggressiveness to drive Aaron Ellis. Aaron Ellis is a guy that is not quick enough of feet to be able to stick with Justin Carter laterally. Justin sees it, attacks him baseline, and draws the foul.
Carter back at the line. He was 2-for-2 to start this game. And Carter knocks down that one. Justin Carter accounting for all of Blue Jays' points from the free throw line early on here, just a couple minutes in.
And see on the made free throw there. Coach Allman wants to go full court pressure or three-quarter court pressure.
Carter misses that one weak, so he goes 3-for-4. Jays down 5-3. Here comes Clevin Hanna, center of the floor. Antoine Young waits for him across the timeline. Hanna, bounce pass to Ray Murray, guarded by Darryl Ashford. That's a good matchup. Bounce pass inside Durley, left block, guarded by Lawson. Harriman's going to harass him. Top of the key, they go Hatch. Hatch sets up wing, re-entry pass to Durley. He's going to rise up for a jumper. No good, but Ellis, weak side, rebound again, right up and through two Blue Jays. Hatch, top of the key, three, high in the air. No good. Durley has it taken away by Darryl Ashford, who gives it up. Young on the run. Antoine, top of the key, right wing Carter. Jays down 5-3 here. Left wing now, Ashford. Man-to-man defense. Ashford driving hard to the left. Ashford, ball knocked away. Ball to the floor. Ashford's got it. Clears it out, Carter, right wing Young. Antoine working on Hannah, drives down left side, floater on the way, no good. Tip, no good. Oh my, Aaron Ellis comes away for Wichita. On the run, Toure Murray into front court. Hesitates, down inside, shot up and good. Toure Murray and draws the foul.
Well, on the offensive end, Creighton getting close to the basket. Antoine Young with a drive, misses a little 10-footer. Kenny Lawson misses the tip-in, but then on the other end, Teray Murray, terrific crossover dribble to his right with Darryl Ashford on him, then spins off him, goes right to the basket and goes through the contact, chance for a three-point play. So you're seeing Wichita State finish the shots close around the basket. Creighton not able to knock those shots down right now.
Murray, a 74% free throw shooter, will step to the line for the first time this afternoon. Goes to the line more than any other Shocker, 49 of 66 on the season. Jays down 7-3 before this free throw. Murray's free throw is on the way, and it is no good. Pops out. Pielle Stadette in the game, along with Wayne Runnels, Ethan Rogge. Carter driving inside. Hard foul, Aaron Ellis. Justin Carter, again, very aggressive. Never slowing down.
And that's a good job by Pielle Stadette to look up the floor, hit Carter, who had a step on Ellis, and attacks. Now let's see how Pielle Stadette does. He came off the bench against Southern Illinois, and he's come off the bench a couple times. Coach Altman's tried to switch things up, and I think every game he's been, he's come off the bench. I liked his demeanor, his attitude. He had 19 points in a game at Indiana State coming off the bench. See how he does this afternoon.
Carter's free throw is good. 4 for 5 this afternoon in the ball game now. Gabe Blair for Greg Marshall and Wichita State. Also Garrett Stutz, the 7-footer, sophomore out of Kansas City. Blair and Stutz, the two bigs. Gabe Blair at 6'8". Justin Carter back at the line for the Jays. Misses that one. And with the rebound, Graham Hatch. So all the Jays' points so far from the free throw line have not got a field goal yet. We're 4 minutes in. Clevin Anna now guarded by Andrew Bach in the ballgame now for Antoine Young. Tareem Murray, pump fake. Got to kick it back out. It's a 7-footer. Stutz out, Hannah. Clevin Anna will play about 30-some minutes. There's a top of the key three, no good. Blair runs it down. Long shot, long board. Blair back out, Murray to Hatch. He's going to set up on the wing. Entry pass. Stutz, double team. Outside. Shot off the glass. Is no good. And Ethan Rogge with the ball clears it out. Sweeping away. Hatch gives up Andrew Bach, the freshman from California, on the run. To Rogge. Right wing, Carter. Guarded by Blair. Top of the key, Stinnett. He's guarded by Teray Murray. Down inside is Runnels. He's got to kick it out. Throws it right into the hands of Murray. Turnover, Jays.
Yeah, Runnels lost the handle on the spin. He tried to do his patented quick spin move baseline, lost the ball, was falling out of bounds, and threw it away.
7-4, Jays down. Hannah moves to the right wing. Now a little stutter step. Top of the key, Gabe Blair. Back out, Hannah. Hannah on the move, through the screen, left side, driving inside. Foul by Andrew Bach. Hannah can't finish, but he's going to shoot 2 free throws. Timeout on the floor. 14:58 remaining in the first half. Jays trail 7-4. Shockers going to the line when we come back on Big Sports 590.
Liberty Tavern is the perfect place for great food and meeting great people. Located on the lobby level of the Hilton Omaha and across the street from the Quest Center, Liberty Tavern offers distinctively American cuisine prepared by one of Omaha's premier chefs, served in a comfortable setting. And Liberty Tavern patrons can park for free at the Hilton Omaha. Creighton fans on those winter nights, take advantage of the hotel Skybridge to beat the cold. And be sure to stop in on game days for pre- and post-game specials. Liberty Tavern, open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner daily, including Sunday brunch. Located at 10th and Cass inside the Hilton Omaha.
Roden Auto Center is the dealer you can trust for anything automotive. Inside Roden Auto Center, you'll find Loan City. People helping people get financed when others can't. There's a state-of-the-art service facility where we service all makes and models, plus Hertz rental car, mobile glass department, and certified body shop. In addition, Roden has new Pontiacs, Buicks, GMCs, Suzukis, and 500 pre-owned. Roden has served the Midwest since 1971, and we'll be here tomorrow. Lake Manawa exit, Council Bluffs. Online 24-7 at RodenAuto.com.
At RBC Wealth Management, they're proud of their steadfast commitment to their clients' financial goals. But you may not know about their long-standing commitment to giving back to the communities they serve. It's how they've done business for over 100 years. The Human Touch selections from the RBC Wealth Management Art Collection is currently on view at Joslyn Art Museum through April 16th. Don't miss this special exhibition of contemporary artworks devoted to the human figure. RBC Wealth Management. We make investing work for you. A division of RBC Capital Markets Corporation, member NYSE, FINRA, SIPC.
Blue Jay Basketball is brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there for all your insurance needs. Call Jay Burkmeyer at 895-7500. And by Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear, your Midtown headquarters for Blue Jay Apparel. And by Fernando's Cafe and Cantina, Sonoran-style Mexican food made fresh 7 days a week.
That's every day of the week.
That is every single day of the week, T-Scott. It's unbelievable.
7-4, Jays down. to the Shockers of Wichita State. And Shockers going to the line to shoot two free throws right now early on. Creighton, folks, 0 for 6 from the field, 0 for 1 from downtown, and hanging in there on the boards. But again, Wichita State just 3 of 9. Creighton is doing a good job, Nick, of making things difficult on the Shockers. But the Shockers, their points, I would bet you that almost all of them have come on second chance points. Whether it was Hatch, whether it's Ellis keeping a shot alive, at least 5 of those 7 are second chance points.
Yeah, and again, it's all of their length that's bothering Creighton.
Yep.
They're using their
length. Missed a couple of layups already.
Yeah, so defensively, they're able to use their length to bother Creighton on some of those shots around the basket, and they're using their length to get offensive rebounds for the Shockers.
Clevin Anna, the second best free throw shooter in the country at 96%. This young man out of Mississippi is money. He's 46 for 48 coming in.
That's amazing.
That is amazing.
I love his game. Clevin Anna is a guy that's always under control. Great shooter.
Knocks them both down. 9-4, Jays trail. Rogge inbounds Bach. They're going to show full court pressure. Senior Hannah on freshman Bach. He gives off Stinnett. Stinnett working down inside, finds Korver. Wing, Rogge turns down a three. They closed on him early. That very quickly, that was Gabe Blair. Bach working, nowhere to go. Nearly travels now. Bounce pass, Wayne Runnels. Deep three, and that's Andrew Bach. Way weak, barely got to the rim. Here come the Shockers on the run. Clevin Hanna down inside. Clevin Hanna, floater on the way. No good. Bach with the rebound. On the run, left of center, now right of center, Andrew Bach. Rogge, left wing, Korver. Korver. Guarded by Toure Murray. Top of the key is Rogge. Bounce pass, Runnels on the wing. Garrett Stutz at 7 feet, waiting on Wayne Runnels in there. Runnels giving up about how many inches? He pokes that ball away. Korver trying to go into Runnels. Jay is just standing out beyond the arc right now, getting nothing inside. Rogge to Runnels again. Way outside, ball tipped away, maybe make that B. Allen Stinnett, who was trying to post up down there, had the ball poked away from behind with 6 on the shot clock. So Korver to inbound with 6 on the shot clock.
Got to get into something quickly. Bach's going to have to make a play.
Korver in Bach, 5, 4, 3. Andrew Bach, stutter step, down inside, lost the ball, but they're going to call a foul, I believe, on Clevin Hanna.
If I'm not mistaken, that might be 2 personal fouls on Clevin Hanna, which that is huge because he's the guy that runs the show for Wichita State. But Andrew Bach, these are big minutes for him. Dana Altman going with Bach at the backup point guard as opposed to Cavell Witter as Bach steps the line and misses the first.
That free throw. Andrew Bach coming in, 19 of 23, misses that free throw. So Hanna does sit down. And Demetric Williams will replace Clevin Hanna. Williams, a 6'2 freshman out of Vegas. Bach knocks down the second one, so the Jays, all their points coming from the free throw line with 6 minutes gone in the first half. Wow. Some teams are just a tough matchup for you, Nick. And the Wichita State is a tough matchup for Creighton.
Well, in all the games,
and a lot of teams,
Wichita State leads the Valley in field goal percentage defense.
Now Blair, top of the key. Rogge out on Gabe Blair. He finds Demetric Williams, who finds Toure Murray. Nope, make that David Kyles now. Stutz down inside, Murray up and under, no good. Rebound taken out by David Kyles. Yet another second opportunity. Toure Murray pump fake now. Garrett Stutz, a 7-footer right block. Trying to back down on Runnels. Stutz shot on the way, no good. Rimmed out. Korver with the rebound. Up comes Bielan Stinnett with no numbers. Cross court to Korver. Korver skip pass Bach. High wing Rogge. Back to Korver on the left wing. Guarded by Toure Murray. Top of the key is Rogge. Finds Runnels. Runnels with Stutz on his back. Hands off Bach. Bach nowhere to go. Trying to get it in Runnels. Denied by Stutz. Timeout. Andrew Bach. Wayne Runnels really not doing much to try to get away from Garrett Stutz right there, Nick.
Well, and neither were his teammates there. Caleb Korver kind of just sat out by the half court line and didn't really try and make himself an available receiver when Andrew Bach got in trouble. Andrew Bach gets some big minutes here.
And he did not play at Wichita.
And so it's going to be interesting to see how he handles this. And right now, clearly, when the ball is away from either Andrew Bach or Antoine Young, Clevin Hanna was sinking way off Antoine Young and helping. And Demetric Williams is doing the same thing against Andrew Bach. But when Andrew Bach has the ball, Williams is all over him, trying to make things difficult for him. We'll see what Coach Altman wants to do, if he wants to come back with Antoine Young. I think he checked back into the game and see how much Cabell Witter wants to play, because they're going to need someone to be able to step up and knock down a perimeter jump shot, possibly from the point guard position, if they're going to continue to sag off and help.
Jays have only gotten off 2 3-point attempts in the first 7 minutes of this first half. They are 0-for-7 from the field, 0-for-2 from beyond the arc right now. Incredible numbers with 7 minutes gone.
Well, I think when the ball doesn't get swung around the perimeter,
yes,
when you allow length to just get set, it is really difficult to be effective
and
against and go against.
The Shockers are just sitting there.
Yeah, they're Creighton's allowing Wichita State just get their defense set.
All right, Antoine Young drives down inside, goes out Harriman, who loses it, so it goes Korver, he loses it. Turnover, Jays. Not good. Hatch, three, off the iron, no good. Blair with inside position. Gabe Blair clears it back out. Graham Hatch, second chance opportunity, right block. Stutz has it knocked away by Kenny Lawson Jr.
Coach Altman's arguing, yeah, I'm not so sure that.
And they're going to give it to Creighton.
Yeah,
good job of lobbying by Dana Altman.
Well, and I agree. Graham Hatch was trying to feed the post down to Stutz, and looked like he just threw an errant bounce pass to nobody. And I think it was such a bad pass, they figured it was deflected. And so Greg Marshall obviously doesn't agree.
Greg Marshall beside himself, crowd letting him have it. Antoine Young, up Harriman, back Young. Boy, they're doing a nice job of denying the Jays' wings. Kenny Lawson facing up on Stutz, travels with the basketball.
Wichita State basketball.
And you just said it right there, doing a really good job denying wings. I think Creighton's maybe got to think about running a backdoor play to relieve some of this wing pressure that Wichita State is applying.
Demetric Williams at the point for the Shockers, throws it away. Hand on the bench with two fouls. Korver on the run, Antoine Young, Wichita State back quickly. Lawson puts the ball on the floor and loses it, but a reach-in foul will be called on Demetric Williams. Lawson once again putting that ball on the floor and losing the handle.
Wichita State foul.
See a couple of Jays right now be a little lackadaisical with the basketball. When you put it on the floor, Wichita State's going to be scrappy and try and get a piece of that basketball. Got to be strong with it, but Kenny was in that particular instance.
Young looks to get it in, finally does get it in. Harriman out near the timeline, back over P. Amistad. He's guarded by David Kyles. Hands off Young. They switch places on the floor. Young moves right. Picks up his dribble, nowhere to go. There's Harriman, denied by Blair. P. Ellenstedt with a flush, got away from David Kyles, and there's the first field goal of the game for Creighton with 8 minutes gone.
Well, and that's that back door. It was a set back door play to get P. Allen to relieve some of that pressure. Slam dunk, and the crowd's alive.
Gabe Blair guarded by Casey Harriman. Harriman giving up about 4 inches on Blair. Got nowhere to go, and Blair puts the ball on the floor. Harriman all over him, clears out, Stutz the big guy, top of the key, over David Kyles on the wing, over to Hatch. On the wing, bounce pass, again knocked away from Stutz on the right side by Lawson. Timeout on the floor, 11:26 remaining first half. Jays down 9-7 to Wichita State, back after this on Big Sports 590.
It pays to cross the bridge to Lake Manawa Nissan.
4 out of 5 customers shop at Lake Manawa Nissan again and again. Why? The answer is simple. Over 30 years of treating you right. Always a huge selection and the lowest prices in the heartland. But that's not all. Every new Nissan comes with our exclusive 10-year powertrain warranty and free oil changes for 3 years. Hurry into Lake Manawa Nissan today.
It pays to cross the bridge to Lake Manawa Nissan. It pays to cross the bridge to Lake Manawa Nissan.
Creighton Athletics would like to thank the following Wheels Club sponsors for their support. Deers Ford Lincoln Mercury, Classic Chevrolet, Cadillac, and Lake Manawa Kia, Auto Express, Old Mill Toyota, Plaza Pontiac Buick GMC, Roden Auto Center, Sid Dillon, Buick, Pontiac, Cadillac, Mazda, Tincture Auto Mall, H&H Chevrolet, and Roy's Grand Dodge Chrysler Jeep Mazda. You help keep the Blue Jays rolling.
Construction contractors and landscapers, rent your way to greater profits with Bobcat Equipment at Bobcat of Omaha. From the heavy work right down to the fussy stuff, Bobcat loaders, excavators, and telescopics handle all the tough tasks, lifting, digging, pushing, carrying, as well as the most precise applications, grading, leveling, and laying sod. Tough jobs demand tough equipment, so when you have a tough job to do, rent the Bobcat brand from Bobcat of Omaha.
Blue Jay basketball is brought to you by Gateway Collision Center. Gateway Collision Center is your answer for collision repair this season, and they're willing to work with any insurance company. Dial 932-0500 and by the Dubliner Pub. your pre- and post-game destination for all Blue Jay home games, and by Security National Bank, serving the community we call home.
All right, 10 on the shot clock for the Shockers as they'll inbound under their own hoop. Teray Murray will do the duties for the Shock. You got Durley and Hatch and Blair and Kyles on the floor. Antoine Young, Bielan Sedet, Caleb Korver, Casey Ehrman, and Kenny Lawson. Kind of a different five out there.
Well, right now with Hannah's foul trouble with this lineup right here, it looks like Teray Murray is going to have to handle the basketball for Wichita State. Maybe could take away some of his effectiveness scoring the ball, but we'll keep an eye on that. But the situation we're in right now, you said it, 10 on the shot clock. Jays like to go in that 2-3 matchup zone on baseline of bounds underneath, so you have to find Graham Hatch.
And despite going 1-for-8 from the field, Creighton finds himself only down 2-9-7.
And not the prettiest of basketball games thus far.
3-for-13, Wichita State, look at that side. 23% for the Shocks. All right, 10 on the shot clock. Teray Murray inbounds. Hatch on the far wing. Out Blair, 7 on the shot clock. Give up Teray Murray. Watch him drive. 4 on the shot clock. 3. Long 3 on the way. Another nylon. Stinnett did not get out on him at all. And they just let him shoot it.
Really bad defensive awareness of the shot clock there. Got a crowd to Ray Murray in that situation.
So Jay's now down 12-7. Harriman hands off Stinnett. Left wing Harriman looks inside Lawson. Lawson guarded inside by Durley. Hook shot on the way is good. Ray Lawson, he could do that all day long if he gets that kind of position on JT Durley.
And you got to love where I said in the pregame, get where you want to get to. Kenny Lawson really lowered his base there. Good jump stop, get close to the basket, jump shot, good.
And P. Allen Stinnett called for a foul 94 feet from the basket as P. Allen trying to knock the ball out of bounds on Murray gets called for his first personal foul. Jays down 12-9. Shock will inbound. And Jays will back off. Teray Murray is bringing the ball up the floor. Young waits for him. Antoine Young. Now Murray. Bounce pass. Top of the key. Gabe Blair. Guarded by Harriman. Bielan Sedet falls down. Gets up. Hatch puts it off the glass and good.
Bielan Sedet needed to get up a little bit quicker there. Hatch kind of threw him to the ground and Sedet laid there for a second trying to get a call but didn't get it and Hatch gets a layup.
14-9. Shockers. Korver. Top of the key. Sedet. Guarded by Kyles. Through a Harriman screen, P. Allen driving inside, P. Allen off the glass, no good, no call. Durley altered that, one of the two, either he or Gabe Blair. Down inside, David Kyles driving hard to the right, shot, no good, weak side, rebound Durley. Durley rejected by Lawson, tracking it down is Teray Murray. Jumper on the way, no good, weak and into the hands of P. Allen Stinnett up the center of the floor, no numbers. Lead pass, Antoine Young. Young, door shut by Murray. Over to Korver, to Harriman, back Korver. Beyond the arc, right side, Stinnett, right wing. Young, Lawson, double team. Lawson going to his left. Kenny, tough shot, hard off the back heel, no good.
See, he didn't get what he wanted to get there. He faded away. That's a tough shot, a low percentage shot for Kenny Lawson.
Teray Murray up in the front court. Gives it up to Gabe Blair. 14-9 Shockers. Hatch, entry pass, right side, Durley. Double team. Cross court out to Murray on the wing. Pump fake. Back out Blair, top of the key, Hatch. Right wing, Kyles. Jays closed with 14 on the shot clock. Bounce pass, right side Durley again. Turns around, nowhere to go. Tries to split the double team. Blair kicks out Kyles. Shot of the way, it's a three and it's good. But they're going to call an offensive foul beforehand. Good near the whistle. Charge taken by guess who?
Casey Harriman.
Leads the team and charges taken.
That's as good of a half-court defensive possession out of Creighton I've seen possibly all season long. They trapped the post twice. They communicated and scrambled out of that. Flew out to the shooters, made hat swing it, made Kyle swing it, and it ends up in a charge. Casey Harriman doing a really nice job, and now the crowd coming alive for the energy man, Chad Miller, checking back into the game. See if he can have the same magic he had on Wednesday night.
Carter also back, along with Darryl Ashford, joins Harriman and Young, and they clear it up to Harriman. He finds Antoine Young, right side, near side, center of the floor, on the run. Young, door is shut by Durley. Top of the key, Harriman, right wing, Young, drives down inside, nowhere to go, layup is good. Antoine Young just too fast.
Good job refusing the ball screen. Instead of going middle, he jabs, goes baseline, gets a layup.
Ethan Rogge at the table for the Jays. Teray Murray at the point, Clevin Hanna on the bench with two fouls. Murray goes Kyles, top of the key, Ellis, guarded by Harriman. Back right wing, Kyles. Down on the wing is Teray Murray, driving inside on Young. Travels with the basketball, no, they're gonna call a foul. Might be on Miller. He was the Jay in the vicinity.
A foul on Chad Miller. Came over and tried to help, kind of shut the door, and they felt like he got a little bit of Teray Murray's hand, almost a travel for Murray, but it ends up in a foul on Miller.
So Miller picks up his first personal. That's the fourth team foul on the Jays. Murray goes back to the line this afternoon. Teray Murray has 0-for-1 from the free throw line. Murray 74% coming in. He knocks. No, that one rims off the back as well. I had that baby dead in. Caught the front of the rim and then rolled off the back. Murray now 0 for 2 from the line this afternoon. Shockers just up 14 to 11. Creighton 3 of 12 from the field. Murray makes the second, and it's 15-11. They inbound Antoine Young. Young on the run, trying to trap him along the sideline. Clear up Millard. Roggi, three on the way. Nothing but nylon, Egan Roggi.
That's just a terrific pass from Chad Millard right there.
Catch and shoot.
The situation that Raggy trailing, flips it back to him, bucket. Good play from Millard, and Roggy's a beneficiary of it.
Tere Murray into front court, heads to the right side, Young on him. Top of the key, Durley between the circles, left wing Hatch, left wing David Kyles. Back Murray through a screen. Top of the key, Hatch again. Carter on him, bounce pass to the right elbow. JT Durley puts the ball on the floor, they double him, kicks it out, Kyles. 12 on the shot clock for the Shockers. Jays down 15-14. Tere Murray with the ball on the high wing left side. Under the screen, Millard shows. Tere Murray, same spot, three on the way, weak, no good. Pushing the back on JT Durley, absolutely.
Chad with just another terrific defensive possession. Great hedge of the ball screen, gets back, battles JT Durley, and gets the offensive foul on Durley.
7:54 remaining first half. We got a timeout on the floor. Jays will have the ball when we come back, trailing Wichita State 15-14 on Big Sports 590.
Safe and effective. Now you get both guaranteed. 8-Ball Nutrition Products are manufactured right here in Omaha and are guaranteed to be free of any banned substances as governed by the NCAA and World Anti-Doping Agency. Vitamins, proteins, amino acids, pre-workout boosters, and more, 8-Ball Nutrition offers student-athlete, military, law enforcement, and firefighter discounts. Products and discounts are available at 8BallNutrition.com or stop by 13724 Industrial Road. 8-Ball Nutrition, university-tested, athlete-approved.
Big Fred's Pizza at 119th and Pacific is a sports fan's paradise. Sports memorabilia covers the walls. The ticker keeps you up on all the latest scores. But the best thing about Big Fred's is the menu, because that's where you'll find award-winning pizzas, thick, juicy burgers, and so much more. So grab the team, grab the family, and grab a seat at Big Fred's. Hot pizza, cold beer, and sports. Is this heaven? Nope. It's Big Fred's Pizza at 119th and Pacific. Family-owned for three generations.
Master's Choice Corn Hybrids and Blue Jay Basketball are upsetting major competition in grain yields every season. For 30 years, Master's Choice Corn Hybrids has proven itself with superior conventional corn genetics and understands the drive of Blue Jay Basketball. Master's Choice, dense stalks, deep roots, high yields, and Blue Jay Basketball should be all that's on your mind this season. Contact Master's Choice Corn Hybrids at 1-866-444-1044 or visit masterschoice@seedcorn.com for more information.
Blue Jay Basketball is brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there for all your insurance needs. Call Jim Sullivan at 333-1127. And by Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear, your Midtown headquarters for Blue Jay Apparel. And by Payflex. When it comes to your payroll operation, Omaha's Payflex will be the easiest vendor you ever work with and the most valuable. Payflex, delivering on the promise.
Jays right now getting outboarded by 15-11 in Wichita State. 7 offensive rebounds already in the first 12 minutes of this basketball game.
Well, again, Chad Millard has come off the bench and given Creighton a pretty good lift in terms of energy.
Yep, great pass to Roggi. Great block out that time on Durley, who ended up having to push him in the back trying to get the rebounds. And now Chad's going to the free throw line. On Wednesday, Millard stepped to the line a couple of times and completed two old-fashioned three-point plays for his 6 points. Let's see what Chad does when he steps to the line here this afternoon. Millard, on the season, had been scoreless from the line. Coming in, he's just 2 for 5 after playing very limited minutes all year.
And when Chad's in the game offensively, it changes what they do. Everything's more perimeter-oriented, a lot of ball screen stuff from beyond the arc.
Millard makes that free throw. You talk about a home court roll, baby. I mean, that thing bounced around for about 5 seconds.
There's about 5 or 6 bounces there, and it goes down for Chad Millard. Mr. Energy, hey, you make your own luck. When you're playing hard, things will go your way.
Second free throw coming up for Millard. He's tied the game, and he gives the Jays their first lead. Despite shooting 30% from the field, Creighton is holding Wichita State to 26%. Talk about a pitcher's duel. Aaron Ellis to Graham Hatch, up to Garrett Stutz. Back Hatch, center of the floor, finds Tere Murray. Jays up 1-16-15. This is the first time they've led Wichita State in 2 games.
Look out.
Down inside, Murray on the feed, no good, and Ashford ends up tipping it to Millard, who finds Antoine Young, left side, far side. Now Twan in the center of the floor, moves to the near side. High wing right side, Trey Murray waits for him. Now Ellis shuts the door, Rogge guarded by Ellis. Sets a screen, Antoine Young drives baseline, jumper, tough shot, no good off the iron. Into the hands of David Kyles, here come the Shockers on the run. Right side is Kyles, center of the floor to Stutz. Stutz can't find anybody to get rid of it. Now he finds Trey Murray, high wing left side. Centers it back up, Hatch. Carter comes out on him between the circles. Hatch moves to the right wing, high wing. Through the screen, Millard shows. Left wing, Murray again. 14 on the shot clock. Murray all the way to the right elbow. Murray got to dish it off. Stutz. Stutz backing in on Millard. Stutz loses the basketball. Stolen and tipped by Young into the hands of Rogge. On the run, Antoine Young did not see Justin Carter. Rogge, three on the way. Hard off the back iron, no good. Murray with the rebound. Here come the Shockers.
It's a pretty good play from Antoine Young to try and get Rogge a triple.
Hatch will try to answer with a three and does. Graham Hatch, right wing. 6-point swing right there.
Yeah, you relax just for a second in transition, and they burn you. Hatch with a triple right in front of the Creighton bench.
18-16. Hatch had three threes against Creighton on Saturday. Justin Carter driving inside on Hatch. No call. Top of the key. Millard turns down an open three. Millard again. Stutz on him. Right side Carter. Bounce pass to Ashford working on David Kyles. There's a high jump shot, high arcing shot from Ashford that drops down.
Haven't seen very much of that posting up from Ashford. That's pretty nice though. Face up, jab, create some space with Kyles and knocks down a little 15-footer.
Tied at 18 apiece. Hatch guarded by Carter. Top of the key, Stutz. Jays looking, trying to be active in the passing lanes. There's Trey Murray. Going right, going left, going right. Trey Murray at the free throw line. Kicks it out, Kyles. Ashford going for a steal. Free throw line, bounce pass, inside Stutz, can't handle it, turnover, Shockers. Tied at 18 apiece, 5:44 remaining first half, fast-paced first half.
And I can't stress enough how good a defensive possessions Chad Millard has had. He's been unbelievable at hedging ball screens, has really pushed Wichita State out towards the timeline and created a lot of havoc just by hedging ball screens. And Chad's going to stay in the game, but Cavell Winter now in instead of Andrew Bach. See how he does.
Senior out of Kansas City at the point now. He'll be going against Clevin Hanna, who's back in the ballgame playing with two fouls, final 5:35 here in the first half. Winter, a lot of dribbling. Number three going against number three. Top of the key, Millard. For a moment, showed ball to Stutz. Now Witter again, nowhere to go. Left wing, Rogge, left baseline, Ashford. Millard sets the screen, Ashford to the right with seven on the shot clock. Top of the key, Carter, three on the way. Off the back iron, no good. Over the back on Chad Millard. Seven-footer Garrett Stutz with the rebound. And that will just be team foul number five on the Jays.
One of those offensive possessions where they kind of left Cavell Witter hanging there. He was dribbling, trying to change sides of the floor to initiate offense. No one was doing a good job of making themselves available, and it kind of got everybody out of sync, and it forces Carter to take a long-range triple, and Chad tries to get a rebound and gets called for a foul.
We're tied at 18 apiece. Clevin Hanna, top of the key. Left wing Hatch to Stutz. One dribble, cutting inside Murray. Blocked from behind by Millard, and he's called for the foul, and Trey Murray going back to the free throw line.
Set play from Wichita State to relieve some pressure to go back door with Murray. Takes Carter back door and Millard, Mr. Energy Man, tries to come off Stutz and block the shot. He definitely blocked it, but they must have felt like he got a little bit of body along with it. So now Chad's got two fouls.
Lawson, Stinnett, and Harriman at the scorer's table getting set to check in. At the line, Trey Murray. One for three this afternoon. And that one rolls down. Breaks the tie. We're tied 19-18 with 5 minutes left in the first half.
They got Chad Millard with three personal fouls. So I can't remember his first one, but
I don't either, but it must have been right out of the gate. So Murray back to the line now. 5 minutes remaining in this first half. Trey Murray's second free throw, another Benai lock. So 2018 Shockers, they inbound Witter. Witter working against Dimitri Williams, up in a front court. Witter moves to the wing, top of the key, Harriman. Backdoor cut is Stinnett. P. Allen Stinnett, shot rejected. Ball on the floor, and Ashford trying to tie it up. Do they get a timeout call, or do they call a jump? They'll give the timeout to Wichita State. We'll keep it right here.
Well, that was an unbelievable pass from Casey Harriman on another set backdoor play to Stinnett, and Stinnett gets it on the right side of the basket, tries to go up and finish on the other side of the basket, but the athleticism and length of Gabe Blair He saw that, met him on the other side of the rim, blocked the shot, created a scramble situation, and Greg Marshall with a heads-up timeout there to retain possession for Wichita State.
4:44 showing on the clock here remaining in the first half. Jays down 20-18. Take a quick look at the stats, Nick.
Well, right now, as you said, I mean, this isn't going to be a first half of basketball you hang at the Smithsonian. I mean, it's been an ugly half offensively. Both teams shooting below 30%. Creighton 5 of 18, Wichita State 6 of 21. Right now, Jays getting out-rebounded 19-12. And leading the way for Wichita State, it's been all Teray Murray. He's got 10 points to lead all scorers. High scorer for the Blue Jays is Justin Carter with 4, and all those 4 points coming from the free throw line.
All right. Club and Hannah working against Cavell Witter. Number 3 on number 3. Couple of seniors. Gives it up Gabe Blair, left wing Hatch. Looking inside to the 7-footer Stutz. He's got Lawson on his back, left block. Travels with the basketball, Garrett Stutz. Turnover on the Shockers. That is the 6th turnover on Wichita State.
And interesting there, they decided not come with a double team. Let Kenny Lawson play Stutz straight up, and Stutz shuffles his feet as he's beginning to make the move and travels, but now some full court pressure from Wichita State.
Harriman triggers it in Ashford. Witter is denied, so Ashford's got it. And they're going to call a reach-in foul on Demetric Williams, and that will send Daryl Ashford to the line for the 1-1.
Wichita State foul number 5, Demetric Williams.
Daryl Ashford going to the free throw line. Ashford on the season just 67%, 21 of 31. So he can tie this game from the free throw line with 4:22 remaining first half. Ashford steps the line for the first time this afternoon.
And that's now Demetric Williams' second personal foul, who is the backup point guard. So both point guards for Wichita State in foul trouble.
Greg Marshall brings Clevin Hanna back in for offense after the Ashford free throws. Daryl Ashford's first free throw, hard off the back iron, no good. Jays missed the front end of a 1-1. Looks like a turnover. Hanna on the run, left side, near side, now center of the floor. Witter up on it. Goes right wing. Teray Murray driving on Ashford, spins inside. Nowhere to go. Blair comes to help, runs Harriman through a screen, back Murray on the far wing. Teray Murray driving to his left side, shot up, no good, foul on a Blue Jay. Wow. Teray Murray feeling it here this afternoon.
Yeah, he's been the most aggressive and the most comfortable individual player in this game thus far. He's given the Jays fits, driving to the basket and scoring in a multitude of ways. Driving right past Ashford with his left hand all the way to the basket, and is going to have a chance now to go to the line where he's only 3 of 5 for the afternoon.
Shock's already up to 20-18 with 4:01 remaining first half. Teray Murray bends his knees, free throw on the way is no good. Well, luckily, he's not hitting them.
Right, because he's done a good job of getting to the line and being aggressive.
Right now, Teray Murray doesn't think there's a Blue Jay that can guard him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's the most confident and comfortable player in this game. And so far, there isn't a Jay that can guard him.
No. Murray's second free throw coming up is good. So it's a 3-point game. Wichita State up 21-18. Harriman looks to get it in. Stinnett makes himself available with Kyles on him. Now Stinnett finds Witter. Witter working. Now against Tyler Richardson in the game. Number 23, a 6'5 freshman. So Witter giving up a lot of size. Goes down inside. Stutz shuts the door with a 7-footer. Corver to Harriman. Entry pass. Left block is Lawson. Kinney, hook shot too strong. Stutz got a hand up. Kinney could have made that, but he overcompensated a little bit. Too strong off the back iron. Jays down 3, 21-18. Teray Murray on the move. Through the screen. Moving screen. Gabe Blair. Cavell Witter, nice acting job as well. Smart play by the senior. Draws the foul. Time out of the floor. 3:31 remaining first half. It'll be Blue Jay basketball when we come back. Jays trail 21-18 to Wichita State. This is Blue Jay basketball on Big Sports 590.
You know, at Barrett's Barley Corn, we are the biggest fans of the Creighton Blue Jays, and we know you are too. That's why we've got a free shuttle to and from the Quest Center for all the Jays home games. So you need to come to the Barley Corn before the game and grab a seat on the shuttle. Then after the game, catch the shuttle and we'll bring you back for a little post-game celebration. Enjoy some fine food, good spirits, and great company. We know Creighton Blue Jay fans are the best, and so is Barrett's Barley Corn Pub and Grill, 43rd and Leavenworth.
The Players Club at Deer Creek offers one of the most unique and challenging championship golf courses in the region. Designed by Arnold Palmer with generous bentgrass fairways, winding waterways, and sculptured bunkers, the Players Club is a golfer's dream. And becoming a member has never been easier. For membership information and tee times, call 963-9950. 963-9950. The Players Club, just north of 120th and Military in Omaha.
Talent, teamwork, and commitment. Put them together, you have a formula for excellence. That's why at Omaha Orthopedic Clinic and Sports Medicine, they've assembled a team of the most talented surgeons. Dr. Richard Murphy, Dr. Michael Morrison, Dr. Peter Cimino, Dr. Jason Michaels, and a great support staff, all working together, all committed to one goal, to utilize the latest treatments and technologies that will provide their patients with the highest quality health care possible. Find out more. Go to omahaorthopedic.com. Omaha Orthopedic Clinic and Sports Medicine, a practice of excellence since 1934.
It's time now for our Omaha Orthopedic and Sports Medicine trivia question. Obviously, on Wednesday night, the story was Chad Millard's energy off the bench, scoring 6 points, which was his season high. He had scored 2 points in the previous 23 games. But the question is, what is Chad Millard's career high as a Blue Jay?
You know, Chad Millard's a great example of, you just never know what's going to happen. The young man transferred from Louisville. He's very athletic, very skilled basketball player, but he has been nicked up as much as anybody on the Blue Jay team. And quite frankly, maybe not the toughest guy in the world, but still, he's battled back, and it could be a huge key for Creighton throughout the rest of this season. I mean, as you said, Nick, he brings different things to the floor than Kenny or Wayne Runnels or anybody else, and he's a senior. I mean, he's a mature young guy. You know, the guys like him. He could be a leader.
He brings tremendous feel and basketball savvy with his size, which is something that I think Coach Altman values, and he could be a guy that is very effective from the high post, passing the basketball, scoring the basketball, and I think he's a guy that sense of urgency has been heightened for him because he is a senior. He realizes he only has X number of games left in his career, and yep. So he's a guy that's willing to do anything and everything for himself and for his teammates, and right now you're seeing things pay off for him, but there's no question. You're talking about a guy that played in every game at Louisville as a freshman. We're talking Big East Louisville with Tyquan Dean, Juan Palacios. I think he's a guy that could find a role on this team and be very effective.
All right, Blue Jay basketball. Heron triggers it in far side backcourt to Stenad, who hands off to Witter, being guarded by Ture Murray. Murray, one of the better defenders in the Valley as well.
It's great length.
He's a good defender. So Witter, a lot of dribbling, goes high wing, right side Korver. There's Lawson backing in. There's a hook shot. This one is weak now. So Stutz doing a good job on Lawson. Kenny can't get a feel for it. And on the run is Murray to Hatch on the wing. Korver stays on his feet. Stutz is going to try a three and knock it down. Garrett Stutz, 3 of 13 on the year, knocks down his fourth three ball, and that's just frosting on the cake right there for Greg Marshall. Entry pass, Lawson puts the ball on the floor, kicks out Stinnett. 18-foot jumper off the iron, no good. Harriman had it, and a foul on Wichita State. Casey Harriman's going to shoot free throws.
Wichita State foul number 0, Aaron Ellis. That's his second.
So Stutz gives the Shockers their largest lead of the afternoon at 24-18. And then Stinnett misses a baseline jumper, but Harriman with the rebound draws the foul. He'll shoot two. That's the 10th team foul on Wichita State.
You know things are crazy when seven-footers for the opposition are making threes and, you know, 6'3 guys aren't making threes for Creighton as Harriman knocks down the first free throw. And Stutz, it wasn't like he had all day to shoot that thing. He stepped into it with rhythm. I mean, there was people around him a little bit, and he just smoked the puppy.
Harriman will get another free throw here. Try to pull the Jays back to within four with 2:46 remaining first half, and he does knock it down. So Casey 2 for 2 that trip down. Jays right now 7, make it 8 for 12 from the free throw line.
And now they'll go three-quarter court pressure, and they'll probably fall back in that 2-3 zone.
Moving up with the basketball, Gabe Blair, and it's knocked away by Stinnett. And Stinnett's got it, but no, what are they going to call? As the officials are over there talking to Greg Marshall, what is the...
Got a timeout.
When was there a timeout called as they were... Play was... And Stinnett will hand the basketball off. And a timeout. So we'll keep it right here. And a 30-second timeout given to Greg Marshall, and I'm not sure when that was called.
There was a
scuffle for the ball as P. Allen Stinnett had tipped it away, and everybody was watching that, and apparently Marshall was over there with another one of the officials,
And while there's players scrambling to the basketball, they're having a conversation.
Well, it could have been a situation where the official didn't have the whistle in his mouth, wasn't ready to make the call, the one that was closest to Greg Marshall, because I think he could sense that Wichita State was fairly flustered by Creighton's three-quarter court pressure. Bottom line, he got the timeout, possibly in time, so Wichita State will retain possession.
Wow.
2:35 remaining first half. Shockers up 24-20. Hatch triggers it into Murray. Murray working in backcourt. Bounce pass over to Gabe Blair. Gabe Blair near side back to Murray in front court. Terry Murray pulls up on the wing between the circles. Hatch back left wing Murray. Goes right. Stinnett left side now to Blair. Blair back out Murray on the wing. Pump fake takes B. Allen Stinnett. Travels with the basketball. Terry Murray just kind of stumbled there.
Yeah, he was a little off balance on that drive, and you can see Greg Marshall yelling at Terray Murray to shoot it. He had a shot on the initial catch. Instead, he gets off balance and travels.
Winter trots across the timeline. High wing left side Stinnett. Lawson sets the screen. P. Allen Stinnett drives inside. Harriman turns down a jumper. That door closed by Gabe Blair. Now P. Allen on the wing to Corver to Winter, left side wing. Again, P. Allen, or rather Cavell to P. Allen. P. Allen Stinnett puts the ball on the floor. Foul on the ground will send P. Allen Stinnett to the line for two free throws. Jays in the double bonus, 1:54 remaining first half, trailing Wichita State 24-20. And it's a good thing that Creighton has knocked down 9 of 13 free throws, because they have only made 5 field goals in 18 minutes of play.
Yeah, offensively, they haven't been overly crisp, but that was a good play from P. Allen Stinnett. You got to like when he doesn't do a whole bunch of dribbling and a whole bunch of fancy things. He just picks a direction and goes and draws a foul.
Knocks down the first free throw. He's got another one coming. Again, he can pull the Jays to within 2 here. Oh, under 2 minutes remaining on the clock.
Yeah, Jays got to find a way to score offensively. They've struggled last Saturday against Wichita State, and it's the same kind of story here this afternoon against the Shockers.
P. Allen Stinnett knocks them both down. The junior out of Las Vegas. We're a 2-point game. Jays need to stop right here. Get the crowd into it. And put a little doubt in the nines of Wichita State as Gabe Blair nearly loses that basketball in backcourt. Now the big guy is going to bring it up. And Winter tries 10-second call as Gabe Blair just could not get away. Cavell Winter was like a little rat terrier on a Great Dane. I mean, Cavell Winter was all over Gabe Blair, and a 10-second violation. Great defense by the Jays. That got the crowd into it.
Well, and this is where the foul trouble of Hannah and Williams, the two point guards for Wichita State, has given them problems there. 10-second violation.
So now the Jays down 24-22. P. Allen Stinnett. Kenny Lawson Jr. draws the foul. P. Allen drove down inside, dished off to Lawson, and Kenny went up for the flush, and he's fouled. Lawson will go to the line to shoot two free throws.
Again, same thing I was talking about with Stinnett. Nothing too fancy. He just caught the ball in the wing, went hard baseline to his right hand, drove all the way to the basket, forced help, saw the dish to Lawson, and Lawson goes up strong through the contact and chance to knock down two throws.
That is just the first personal foul on Garrett Stutz, the 7-footer.
And right now, Wichita State clearly not liking the three-quarter court pressure without a real point guard on the floor.
And Lawson knocks him down. We're tied at 24 apiece with 92 seconds remaining first half. Kyles inbounds Murray. Back David Kyles. Back over near side Murray. Center of the floor is Stutz. Far side over to Kyles in front court. High wing left side, Murray. On the wing, Graham Hatch. Down inside. And they're going to call a foul on the ground on Caleb Corver. That'll be the 8th team foul on Creighton. So Murray going back to the free throw line. Terray Murray spent a lot of time there this afternoon. He's already 4-for-7.
I think it's Graham Hatch. He was the one
driving. Graham Hatch, that's right. So Hatch driving from the left to the right into the center of the floor, and Caleb just couldn't quite get there.
Well, that's what Hatch is, a terrific three-point shooter. Corver had to make sure he was crowded him on the catch, and Hatch recognized that. He's left-handed, but he went right to the middle and drew the foul. But clearly, the three-quarter court pressure from Creighton back zone has flustered Wichita State.
Hatch, 80% from the line. That rims out. Wichita State, 6 of 10 from the line this afternoon, and that's one of the things that's keeping the Jays in this game. 24-24. That and the Blue Jays good shooting free throws. There's Cavell Winter, the classic pull-up from just inside the free throw line, left side. Winter gives the Jays a 2-point lead with 1 minute remaining. Cavell Winter goes for a steal on Murray. Can't get it. Get up, Cavell. Here comes Terray Murray. It's 5-on-4 now. Winter back on the defensive side. Left wing Hatch. Spin it up on him. Right wing Murray. far wing, Kyles. Ball knocked away by Harriman with 17 on the shot clock.
So communication, again, a premium right now in this 2-3 zone, which Creighton has done a really good job of, but Cavell Witter in the offensive end of the floor. Great individual move. Crossover, knew exactly what to do, popped up, knocked down the jump shot here.
Hatch, far side, front court, triggers it in Murray. Between the circles, just right of center. Now moving up is Murray through the stud screen to the middle of the floor. Fires it high wing left side, Hatch. Stinnett on him with 7 on the shot clock. Murray now. Gotta go one-on-one. Now back over to Hatch. Back over to Murray. 3 on the shot clock. Tari Murray. Top of the key. Rises up. Jumper on the way. No good. And the rebound taken down. Graham Hatch. Oh my. Jays can't get a defensive board when they need one.
And now they'll
Shockers
hold for one.
Hold for the final shot. Jays up 26-24. Tari Murray driving down inside. Back outside. 13, 12, 11. Murray near the timeline. Greg Marshall. Complaining to the officials. Murray now with 5, with 4. Tari Murray through the stud screen. Witter goes over it. Tari Murray driving down inside. Jumper on the way at the buzzer is no good. And Creighton, a good defensive stand right there as the Shockers had 2 chances and a full minute and couldn't get a shot off.
And Cavell Witter did a really good job of fighting over screens.
Yep.
They were trying to free up Murray. He fought over all the ball picks and contested the jump shot. And Jays will go to the halftime with a 2-point lead now.
26-24 at halftime. We'll take a break, come back. Security National Bank Halftime Show is coming up next on Big Sports 590.
When you're looking for the best deal on a new Chevrolet, shop the Chevy Guy. When you want to shop online, shop thechevyguy.com. The largest Silverado selection in the city. 5-star service after the sale. Only at Southwest Iowa's largest Chevy dealer. The Chevy Guy. Classic Chevrolet in Council Bluffs. Take the I-80 Lake Manawa exit. Look for the big yellow sign and get ready to save.
Lawler's Custom Sportswear has everything you need. Lawler's has Omaha's best and biggest selection of Creighton sportswear. Lawler's has Blue Jay t-shirts, hoodies, hats, jackets, replica jerseys, flags, even Blue Jay foam fingers. Check out the 3-for-$39 special. 3 Creighton t-shirts for just $39. Lawler's has 3 locations to serve you. West Roads, Oakview, and the College Superstore at 84th and J. Lawler's Custom Sportswear, a proud supporter of Creighton Athletics.
Make this year your year to catch Arch Madness, celebrating 20 years of Valley basketball in St. Louis. Don't miss the 2010 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Men's Basketball Championship, March 4th through 7th at Scott Trade Center, presented by Diet Pepsi and Fox Sports Midwest. Arch Madness. For tickets, call 314-241-1888. 314-241-1888. Or visit archmadness.com.
All right, welcome to the Security National Bank Halftime Show, where Creighton leads Wichita State 26-24. And before we look at any stats, Nick, just your first initial impression of that first 20 minutes.
Well, I thought they finished strong, which is very important. They finished that final 4 minutes on a little bit of a run. I thought it was all keyed by Coach Altman's adjustment to go to that different press, the three-quarter court pressure, falling back into that matchup zone. I thought it really stymied Wichita State, which allowed Creighton to eventually take the lead offensively. But they're going to have to find a way to be more productive offensively right now. 26 points. They shoot 27% from the field, 6 of 22, just 1 for 6 from beyond the arc, 13-17 from the free throw line. They got to find a way to get the ball movement better, to get the player movement a little bit better so they can have more efficiency offensively.
Well, free throws, which have really plagued the Blue Jays all season long, have been their best friend here this afternoon. They're shooting 76% from the line as a team, and that's why they have the lead, 26-24.
They've outscored Wichita State from the foul line by 7 points, and that's kind of been the difference in the game. You just said it, and it's the Creighton's done a pretty good job offensively at times of being aggressive, but I felt like whenever that ball would stick and they didn't get the thing swung around, that's when the length of Wichita State, they were able to set their defense, and that gave them problems because they are very long and they'll alter a lot of shots, and Creighton, and those percentages go way down against length.
Well, I think it can be lost in the fact that Creighton has been struggling offensively, how good defensively they play.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
a much better job today, Nick, than last Saturday in not letting Wichita State play to their strengths.
Well, and outside of the fact they're going up 8 offensive rebounds,
right,
Creighton's first shot defense has been awesome.
Yeah, and you're getting outboarded. I'll tell you what, we'll take a break when we come back. Nick Ball will just give you a complete rundown of those first half stats. and we can kind of show you what we're talking about here. But the number that matters, 26-24, and that is the Jays with the lead. And we'll be back after this on Big Sports 590.
Security National Bank is your hometown bank, locally owned and managed. Security National Bank offers a wide range of services to its customers, including checking and savings accounts, home and business loans, auto loans, and trust services. Always with competitive rates and designed to meet your needs at 14 convenient locations, including our newest location in Exarban Village. A proud supporter of Creighton Blue Jay basketball, Security National Bank, serving the community we call home. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
At RBC Wealth Management, they're proud of their steadfast commitment to their clients' financial goals. But you may not know about their long-standing commitment to giving back to the communities they serve. It's how they've done business for over 100 years. The Human Touch, selections from the RBC Wealth Management Art Collection, is currently on view at Joslyn Art Museum through April 16th. Don't miss this special exhibition of contemporary artworks devoted to the human figure. RBC Wealth Management. We make investing work for you. A division of RBC Capital Markets Corporation, member NYSE, FINRA, SIPC.
Remember when food didn't come out of a box, a bag, a can, or a microwave? Remember when you could pronounce the ingredients? Then welcome to Lansky's. Enjoy Lansky's hearty pizzas and pastas, or chow down on a Philly or a tender roast beef sandwich. Lansky's, where real food and your taste buds can meet, all in a relaxed atmosphere. Lansky's in Omaha, Bellevue, and Council Bluffs. And don't forget Lansky's daily lunch specials. Welcome to Lansky's.
Welcome back to Security National Bank Halftime Show. T. Scott Maher, Dick Ball here with you, but we're going to take a quick break before we look at those first half stats and welcome another fine corporate sponsor here to Press Row at Quest in Omaha. Dan Miller, Director of Sales Support for First Data. Dan, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
What do you think of the game so far?
It's great. Great to go into the halftime ahead.
Absolutely. Defensive ball game.
Very much so.
Low scoring, 26-24. Talk a little bit about the relationship between Creighton University Athletics and First Data, Dan.
You bet. We've been sponsoring the Creighton basketball team since 2003, so about 7 years now.
And obviously, First Data, a big, very involved in the community, obviously a big part of Omaha.
It is. It is. We do a lot of giving back in the community, and we just got done with our 2009 community care where we adopted 43 families in the community. We raised almost $50,000, had about 1,500 of our First Data employees that were involved in that.
What is on the horizon for First Data?
Well, you know, 2009 was a tough year for everybody.
Sure.
But from what we see, it looks like it's a very promising year coming up.
And again, the relationship, I just want to thank you for supporting Creighton basketball in particular. Obviously, again, Creighton University, First Data, two very important components in the Omaha community.
Exactly, and thanks for having us here.
All right, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
All right, Dan Miller, Director of Sales Support for First Data. We'll take another break, and I bet when we come back, I promise that Nick Baugh will take a look at the first half stats for you. That's coming up next on Big Sports 590.
Oh, you got all of that one.
Enjoy the long walk in the short grass. For thousands of clients nationwide, Golf Tech's certified personal coaches have used superior swing technology and a proven teaching approach to build a game you can trust.
Located just off 114th and Dodge Street, call 402-905-2990 for more information or online at golftechtec.com.
Golf Tech, expect to improve.
I'm T. Scott Maher, voice of the Jays for Fernando's Cafe and Cantina. You know, you travel with the Jays around the country, eat at some great restaurants. But I always enjoy coming home to the unique flavor you can only find at Fernando's Cafe and Cantina. It's the Sonoran-style Mexican food that I love. They're open 7 days a week. They make everything fresh every day. Fernando's has a location close to you, open for lunch and dinner, catering services, banquet facilities, 114th Street South of Dodge, 75th and Pacific, and Main Street in downtown Blair. Fernando's Cafe and Cantina. Try it. You'll love it.
Women know today's delicate fabrics require a dry cleaner with a delicate touch. Trust me, Fashion Cleaners knows what it's doing. That's why Omaha's finest clothing stores, like Sheila's at Countryside Village, count on Fashion Cleaners.
I've always used this phrase, when you dress for yourself, you're always in fashion. When someone can help you with that upkeep, Fashion cleaners can do that.
Ethel Merrigan at Sheila's has worked in women's fine clothing for years. She sees firsthand that expert dry cleaning keeps her customers smiling.
If a customer buys a really wonderful outfit, spends good money, she needs to know what business to send this to. Fashion cleaners we've recommended many, many years. It just extends the life of the garment.
Imports, synthetics, delicate silks, microfibers. Find out why Fashion Cleaners is a woman's best friend. Voted number one, the best of Omaha.
And I think Fashion Cleaners is right on.
When you want to look your very best, choose the dry cleaner that says, your style matters. For a location close to you and special offers, go to fashioncleaners.com.
All right, welcome back. Security National Bank Halftime Show. Jays lead here at halftime, 26-24 with your first half numbers. Here's Nick Baugh.
Start with the Creighton Blue Jays. Obviously, only scored 26 points. Wasn't the best half of offense for them by any stretch of the imagination. They shoot 27% from the field, 6 of 22. They shoot 16% from beyond the arc, 1 of 6. They shoot 76% from the foul line, 13 of 17. They get out-rebounded by Wichita State, 23-15 in that first half. Gave up 8 offensive rebounds to Wichita State. They only turned the ball over 3 times, which is a great number to see. And they had 4 team assists on only 6 made baskets. Not a whole lot of field goals being made in that first half. A couple of guys got 4 points to lead the way. Justin Carter's got 4. All his points coming from the foul line, 4 of 6. Kenny Lawson Jr.'s got 4 points and 3 rebounds. He's 1 of 5 from the field and 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Also, Pion Sinet's got 4 points. Should be noted, he's got 998 career points, 2 shy of a grand. So we'll keep an eye on that. 4 points, 2 rebounds for Pion Sinet. Ethan Rogge knocked down a triple in 7 minutes. Also, chipping in with the deuce, Casey Harriman, 2 points, 2 rebounds in 13 minutes of action. Daryl Ashford had 2 points. Antoine Young had 2 points. And Cavell Witter knocked down a deuce as well. And Andrew Bach made 1 free throw. For Wichita State, again, they out-rebound Creighton 23-15. They have 9 first-half turnovers and 4 team assists on 7 made baskets. They shoot 7 of 24 from the field, 29%. 4 of 9 from downtown, good for 44%. 6 of 10 from the free throw line. Leading the way for Wichita State was sophomore Teray Murray, who was relentlessly aggressive and was very confident in that first half. 11 points, 6 rebounds. He's 3 of 10 from the field, 1 of 3 from downtown, 4 of 7 from beyond the arc. Chipping in with 5 points was Clevin Hanna. He had 5 points and 1 rebound, but he got 2 quick fouls. He only played 7 minutes. That's something to keep an eye on and keep in the back of your head, is that Hanna, their point guard, wasn't in the game for much of that first half. Also, Graham Hatch, who plays with a lot of energy, had 5 points and 4 rebounds and 2 assists in 18 minutes. Only other Wichita State shocker to score was Garrett Stutz, 7-footer, knocked down a 3-pointer. He had 3 points and 1 rebound and 2 turnovers in 13 minutes of action. Points in the paint, all knotted up at 6. Points off turnovers in favor of Creighton, 8-2. They turned the ball, Wichita State turned the ball over 9 times, and Creighton got 8 points off of those turnovers. Second chance points in favor of Creighton, 4-3, in spite of Wichita State only getting 8 offensive rebounds, only turned that into 3 points, which is good to see. Fast break points, Creighton has 3, Wichita State 2. Bench points in favor of the Blue Jays, 12-3. Those are your first half stats, but again, you know, we talked about it, T-Scott, things you got to remember. Clevin Hanna, their trigger man, their catalyst for everything, had 2 fouls, so that is going to make their production offensively not be as crisp. And so I think with him coming back into the game, you've got to think that Wichita State will get things figured out offensively. But Creighton's got to get something figured out, find a way to score the basketball offensively. I mean, just scoring 26 points and shooting 27% from the field is not going to get it done.
Congratulations, by the way, to P. Ellis Tenet for his 1,000th point.
Well, he's too shy, isn't he?
Yeah, no, he got it. He's got 4 points. P. Allen,
they said he was
154.
Okay, good.
So P. Allen with his 4 points, and he's got 1,000 points. Actually, he's the 3rd quickest Jay to get to 1,000 points behind Rodney Buford and Kyle Korver under Dana Altman. So congratulations to P. Allen. Another amazing number to me, Nick, is when you look at the Blue Jays roster and you look at the players that have scored, you've had 6 guys score, but no one has scored more than just 1 basket apiece.
Yeah.
I mean, Lawson 1 for 5, Ashford 1 for 3, Young 1 for 4, Witter 1 for 1, Stinnett 1 for 4, and Rogge 1 for 2. I mean, just incredible numbers, really.
They only got 6 field goals as a team.
Yeah.
I mean,
Again, it's
just been one of those halves that has just been ugly. You got to think and hope that Coach Altman made some adjustments at halftime, see what he wants to do, if he wants to try and go inside to Kenny Lawson, if he wants to try and do more things to maybe go backdoor, alleviate some pressure, and dribble drive. We'll see what Coach Altman wants to do at the start of the second half.
All right, we're going to take our final break. When we come back, we will have the second half for you. Jays, despite all that,
with a two-point lead here to start the second half at 26-24. Back after this on Big Sports 590.
Security National Bank is your hometown bank, locally owned and managed. Security National Bank offers a wide range of services to its customers, including checking and savings accounts, home and business loans, auto loans, and trust services. Always with competitive rates and designed to meet your needs at 14 convenient locations, including our newest location in Exarban Village. A proud supporter of Creighton Blue Jay basketball, Security National Bank, serving the community we call home. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Every day, I choose what's best for my family. Take this tomato. It looks great, but how far did it have to go to get here? When it comes to food, I believe local is best. That's why I buy Roberts Dairy, because they're farmer-owned, and everything comes fresh from a farm in my part of the country, and without added growth hormones. Now that's a decision I can feel good about.
Roberts Dairy. Homegrown freshness from our farms to your table.
Roberts.
As your company expands, you become more dependent on your technology. But have you invested in or upgraded your network, or deserted it and duct taped it as you play the wait and see game with the economy? Now is the time to act. Kidwell are the technology leaders to call. Suppliers are discounting deep. Prices are 20 to 30% lower than they've ever been, but they won't stay that way forever. Don't ignore your network. It supports everything you do. Let Kidwell help you make a wise investment in your infrastructure today.
Boys Town has a tradition of providing game-winning strategies for happy, healthy children. To see how Boys Town can help your family today, visit www.boystown.org. You can help Boys Town write the history of tomorrow by helping a girl or boy today. To see how you can join our mission of saving children and healing families, visit www.boystown.org. www.boystown.org.
Omaha is known for fine restaurants, and there's none finer than Anthony's Steakhouse at 72nd and F. Anthony's offers you a complete dining experience with plenty of well-lit parking, a wait staff that's second to none, intimate seating for two, or banquet facilities for 400, and live entertainment in the exciting Ozone Lounge. From appetizers to entrees and so much more, Anthony's Steakhouse at 72nd and F is Omaha's finest and friendliest restaurant.
All right, we're set for the second 20 minutes of basketball here from Quest Center Omaha. T. Scott Martin and Bob with you this afternoon. Thanks for joining us. Creighton Blue Jays, 26-24, two-point lead here heading into the second 20 minutes. Jays, of course, the Shockers at 16-2, 5-1 in conference play, only one game behind Northern Iowa. I mean, this is a big game for Wichita State, obviously, as well, and Creighton is just trying to keep their head above water.
Yeah, it's a big game for both teams, especially Creighton.
This time of the year in conference play, that's why you love these games, because every game is magnified.
Yeah.
Every game is magnified. Each team has got a reason why it's a huge game for them.
And I love to see halftime adjustments. I love this about college coaches. I love to see what Coach Altman wanted to change at halftime, what he saw from that first 20 minutes, and same with Greg Marshall. First possession, they traditionally like to go inside to Kenny Lawson, but I would be surprised if you maybe see a setback door play to maybe alleviate the pressure even more so right away, soften the defense up. We'll see what they want to do as Creighton's going to have the ball to start this second 20 minutes.
Darrell Ashford will inbound for the Jays. You know, again, the stat sheet shows Wichita State with one block, but again, that is so misleading because they altered so many shots by Creighton. Ashford triggers it in Antoine Young, and the Jays are moving right to left on your radio this half. Young on the right wing centers it up, finds Harriman. Over Young again. Door shut, bounce pass, Lawson, they double him. Hannah goes out on him. Kenny down inside, Kenny shot, no good. Durley got a piece of that, but that's not why Lawson missed it. He just came up weak.
They're just sagging way off Antoine Young when the ball's going into the post to Kenny Lawson right now.
Durley with the ball. Or rather Murray, excuse me. Torrey Murray over to Hannah, top of the key. Hannah working on Young. Looking for a cutter, got to go back out Aaron Ellis. He comes back out Hannah with 15 on the shot clock. Hannah going to the right, top of the key, goes hard left. Shot down inside, oh my. Lawson almost had that, it went right through his hands, into the hands of Durley, who puts it up and down off the glass. We're tied at 26 apiece. Yeah, make it Darryl Ashford. Down inside, Ashford off the glass. No good. Tip in, no good. Lawson trying to save that ball. It's out of bounds. It will stay with Creighton. Kenny Lawson didn't give up on that, and that's why the Jays keep the ball.
Well, and right there with Wichita State on that offensive possession, you're already seeing the influence of Clevin Hanna. That possession was going nowhere, but Hanna makes a play and dishes it off to Durley for a bucket.
On the move now is Justin Carter. Kicks out Antoine Young on the high wing right side. Young through the Harriman screen, comes left, and then finds Ashford on the wing. He'll center it up. Darryl Ashford to Antoine Young. Entry pass, Lawson, left side. Again, Hanna now. Young sets that screen. Ashford on the move. Murray goes for a ball fake. That ball knocked away and out of bounds and into the hands of Hatch. Wow, that's an athletic play by Ture Murray. Clevin Hanna into front court, drives hard past Antoine Young. Durley turns down a jumper. Back it in on Lawson, JT Durley. Facing up, they double-team him. Durley may have to call a timeout. No, off the glass, no good. Gets his own rebound. Lawson fell asleep. Hook shot, no good. Carter comes away with it. Carter up the left side, near side. Hatch slows him down. Good D by Graham Hatch. Right over that screen by Lawson. Right wing Harriman. He's going to try a three ball hard off the iron. Right back to Clevin Hanna. Jays come away empty. My goodness, my goodness. 26-26. Clevin Hanna taking Antoine Young hard to the right side, no good. Lawson's got the rebound. Finds Antoine Young, center of the floor. Young on the move. Durley slows him down. Now Harriman up on the wing, back Young. Left wing, Darryl Ashford, Ture Murray on him on the near side wing. Skip pass, Lawson, right elbow, jumper way weak. Not even close. Ture Murray flying up the left side, far side. Jay's got a stop ball. Murray going down inside, finger roll is no good, but he drew the foul.
It's Ture Murray again being aggressive, whether it's in the half court or in transition, pushing it right at Antoine Young, putting pressure on him, drawing a foul. Murray's made a living at the free throw line. This will be his eighth and ninth free throw foul attempt shots on the afternoon.
Tied up 26 apiece, 17:33 remaining second half. Ture Murray back at the line, 4 of 7 so far today. Murray, a sophomore, he's gonna be around a while. As he rattles that one down. Stinnett, Runnels, and Witter come in for Ashford, Lawson, and Antoine Young.
Cavell Witter, see, it's going to be interesting to see now what Greg Marshall wants to do with Hanna having to guard Witter when the ball goes into the block with Kenny Lawson, if Hannah's going to help out and dig off Witter and leave him a jump shot.
Murray misses that free throw. Ellis over the back. If they're going to call the foul on him, or they're just going to say it went off of him. Yep, they'll just say it went off him. He was over the back of Harriman, who had great inside position. Harriman needs help. Stinnett comes to help him. Stinnett is trapped. Stinnett finds Witter. Now Witter comes safely up to the timeline. Hanna waits for him. Cavell Witter center the floor. Left wing Stinnett. He's open. He'll try the three. It looks good. Nothing but nylon. P. Allen Stinnett. That's the way you do it.
And set play to get P. Allen Stinnett driving to the basket, but when he caught the ball, no one was there. Ture Murray was way off him. He just rose up and knocked down a triple from the left wing. Big shot from Stinnett.
Second three of the game. That's it for the Blue Jays. But they're up two, 29-27. Ellis hands off Murray. Murray sets the right side. Entry pass, JT Durley, right block working on Runnels. They double team him, skip pass. Back and left over side, Graham Hatch inside to Durley. Durley moving around to the left. Oh my, P.L. Stinnett had the ball ricochet off his chest into the hands of the Shocker who put it up and down. Wow, that's living right there. 29-29, we're tied. Witter driving hard to his left. Bounce pass Carter, baseline. Carter shot off the glass, no good. As again, Durley's length influenced that shot. Boy, the Jays just not having any luck going right at Durley. Clevin Hanna down inside, fouled by Justin Carter. For Carter, that is his first personal foul. Second team foul of the half. Tied at 29 apiece. 3.5 minutes into the second half.
David Kiles checking
in for Ture Murray. Get him off the floor for a while. Murray's worked hard in that first half. Playing 19 minutes of the 20 minutes for Greg Marshall. So Kiles will inbound left side under the Shocker hoop. We're tied at 29 apiece. Runnels, Harriman, Witter, Carter, and Stinnett on the floor for the Blue Jays. Hanna, Hatch, Durley, Ellis, and Kiles. Hanna working Stinnett through the Ellis screen, top of the key. Left wing is Kiles. Left block, Ellis back it in. Ellis splits the double team. Jumper is good. My, my, Aaron Ellis.
Yeah, Jays were in that matchup zone. Got switched off where Stinnett was on Ellis. Ellis intelligently takes him to the block and scores right over him.
I said it right out of the gate. I'll say it again. Aaron Ellis is only listed at 6'6". He looks about 6'10". And there's a blocking foul on David Kyles. As P. Ellis for that driving hard to his right, we got a timeout on the floor. 15:58 remaining second half. Shockers have retaken the lead, 31-29. It'll be Blue Jay basketball when we come back on Big Sports 590.
What do you look for in a hotel? Most people say comfort and convenience. You'll find both at the new Fairfield Inn & Suites downtown Omaha. The comfort of a new hotel with spacious rooms, expansive suites, and the latest amenities and furnishings. The convenience of on-site parking, a hot breakfast, and wired or wireless internet, all complimentary. Fairfield Inn & Suites, downtown Omaha, just 3 blocks from the Quest Center at 15th and Nicholas. Safe and effective. Now you get both guaranteed. 8-Ball Nutrition products are manufactured right here in Omaha and are guaranteed to be free of any banned substances as governed by the NCAA and World Anti-Doping Agency. Vitamins, proteins, amino acids, pre-workout boosters, and more, 8-Ball Nutrition offers student-athlete, military, law enforcement, and firefighter discounts. Products and discounts are available at 8BallNutrition.com or stop by 13724 Industrial Road. 8-Ball Nutrition, university-tested, athlete-approved.
Talent, teamwork, and commitment. Put them together, you have a formula for excellence. That's why at Omaha Orthopedic Clinic and Sports Medicine, they've assembled a team of the most talented surgeons. Dr. Richard Murphy, Dr. Michael Morrison, Dr. Peter Cimino, Dr. Jason Michaels, and a great support staff, all working together, all committed to one goal, to utilize the latest treatments and technologies that will provide their patients with the highest quality health care possible. Find out more. Go to omahaorthopedic.com. Omaha Orthopedic Clinic and Sports Medicine, a practice of excellence since 1934.
It's time for the answer to our Omaha Orthopedic and Sports Medicine trivia question. Last Wednesday against Southern Illinois, Chad Miller got it at his kind of coming out party or reemergence party, scoring 6 points, a season high for him, and only had 2 points in the previous 23 games leading up to that. But the question was, what was Chad Miller's career high as a Blue Jay? And the answer is 15 points in his first game as a Creighton Blue Jay against DePaul. Well, I remember that was a season opener, my senior year, Chad's first year here. He had 15 points and did a tremendous job lifting Creighton to victory that game. So that question's brought to you by Omaha Orthopedic and Sports Medicine, a practice of excellence since 1934.
All right, Cavell Witter to inbound for the Blue Jays. They trail by two, 31-29, 15:58 remaining here, second half. Jays had a 2-point lead at halftime. Wichita State's fought back now and retaken the lead. Witter and Reynolds, Rogge on the floor along with Stinnett and Casey Hare, and Justin Carter, excuse me. He's trying to get blocked by the officials, taking a guess there as Rogge gives it up to Carter after the inbound. Carter working against Hatch, he'll hand off to Stinnett, working against Kyles, he'll hand off to Witter now, a little three-guard weave. Hands off to Carter. Justin Carter driving on Graham Hatch, kicks out Stinnett, he just hit 1-3, oh, nope, off the iron, no good. I think we've got to call Aaron Ellis there, yeah, I mean, he had about, there was Durley and Ellis for Wichita State, like three other Blue Jays, they were all kind of like in a cluster.
Well, and Ethan Rogge did a nice job just going to the basket to try and get an offensive rebound, and Ellis had to hold him, and that's going to be Ellis's third personal foul.
Stutz checks in for Durley now, by the way, as Witter looks to trigger in right side, looking to set screens. They get it into Justin Carter, nearly throw it away. Carter gives it back out to P. Allen Stinnett near the timeline.
See if they want to go back to this dribble weave, just try and drive the Wichita State Shockers.
Stinnett does hand off to Witter. Witter looks to drive inside. The 7-footer Stutz is in now, though. That'll change things on the inside. As Stinnett drives hard to his right, and David Kyles will...
They're going to count the bucket.
My, my, there's your continuation rule there. It's kind of like the NBA as Witter just kept going and finished, counted and won. P. Allen Stinnett going to line where he is 2-for-2 this afternoon, and we are tied at 31. Stinnett can break that tie. By the way, due to a typographical error, Aaron Ellis is in fact 6'9", because on our initial flip card it says 6'6", but in the program it's 6'9". So no wonder he looks taller. Stinnett misses that free throw, and Rogge trying to corral it. It's on the floor, and Rogge's got it. Will they call a reach-in foul? Thank you very much. And that may be on Aaron Ellis.
Yeah, if that's on him, it's only three, I guess.
Yep, that is his third down.
To him, but Right now, Creighton, Coach Allman just going to an adjustment in terms of what they're doing half-court offensive-wise. Just spread it out with Carter, Stinnett, and Witter, sticking Rocky in the corner and Reynolds underneath and just driving the ball at Wichita State.
Witter gets it into Stinnett. Door is shut by Teray Marie. Rogge, three on the way. Oh, not even close. That ball barely made it to the rim. Teray Marie on the run. Teray Marie pulls up. Good D, good transition defense by the Jays. Hatch with the ball now between the circles. Hatch through the Stutz screen. Hatch goes left, kicks back out. Stutz is going to try another three. That one no good. Fighting for the basketball is the Jays, and Hatch is going to be called for a push-off. Good call right there.
Hatch is a scrappy player.
Oh, yeah, he is.
Plays very physical, very hard. Went to the offensive glass and battled Justin Carter and got caught with a foul here.
Hatch's a big guy, 6'4", about 203. I mean, he's a big kid.
So here we go. Now let's see if
all
they go back
tied
to the
31. 31 apiece. 14:50 left in this game. Witter comes up to the top of the key. He's going to try a three, and it is going to be good. Cabell Witter, nobody got out on him, and the senior from Kansas City said, I can hit this shot.
Well, that's Clevin Hanna, usually a guy who doesn't make very many mistakes, goes under a ball screen set by Wayne Runnels. Couldn't do that against Witter. That's where he's at his best, shooting jump shots off the dribble.
Shockers come up. Jays with their biggest lead of the day, believe it or not, on just three. Now, Clevin Hanna drives down inside, and before the shot, they're going to call P. Allen Stinnett for the body on Clevin Hanna, who's driving hard to the left. And Runnels was there to shut him down, but they will call the foul, and it will be Shocker basketball under their own hoop with the Jays up 34-31. 14:21 remaining second half. Hanna to inbound, left side of the Shocker hoop. He's got the ball, looking inside, gets it into Hatch, high wing left side, top of the key, Gabe Blair. Wing, Murray, baseline, Hanna, three on the way, off the iron, no good. And a push off on Wichita State. Might be on Stutz.
It's on Gabe Blair.
Gabe Blair, all right then.
Oh, you're right, it's on Stutz.
Yep. Garrett Stutz picks up his second, and that is the 16th foul on the Shocks right now. So the next one will put the Jays in the bonus, 14:15 remaining second half. Ethan Rogge to inbound for the Creighton. Caleb Korver back in the game. Gets it in Stinnett, who finds Witter.
Looks like they're going to go back to the same thing. High ball pick with Reynolds and Witter.
Witter on the move, goes to the right. Stutz is there. Cavell down inside, throws up a shot. And they're going to, that is a savvy senior play as Witter knew the contact was coming, made sure he got a shot off, and gets two free throws.
Yeah, you can see the screen put Clevin Hanna way behind on Witter, and he was trailing him and intelligently stops, little shot fake, jumps into him. Now he's going to have a chance to knock down two throws.
And Hanna's got three fouls.
Yes, and you could just see, even though it hasn't been a great couple of minutes offensively for Wichita State to start the second half, things just work smoother for them with him on the floor.
And they happen a lot faster. As Witter knocks down that free throw, he's got another one coming.
Cavell's done a really nice job offensively.
Yes, he has.
In a lackluster offensive performance by both teams. Off the bench, Cavell Witter's got 6 points right now.
And he's got another free throw coming here. Witter on the season, 75%. A career, first 2 years, 80% here at Creighton. Came in as a sophomore. Knocks them both down. Jay's doing a pretty good job this afternoon from the free throw line. 15 of 20, by golly, that's 75%. All right. Hannah's out. Demetric Williams at the point now. Finds Teray Murray up across the timeline. Stinnett waits for him. Runs it through the screen. Goes left, goes right. Hatch shows ball to Korver. Stays on his feet. Doesn't go for the pump fake. Back out Demetric Williams. Williams will take a long three off the rim. No good. Runnels with a rebound. One and done Shocks. Jays with their biggest lead of the day. 36-31. Top of the key, Witter. Demetric Williams, rhythm dribble. Witter off the iron, no good. Caleb Korver comes in for the rebound, but then throws it into the hands of Hatch. Graham Hatch on the run. Ball knocked away from behind by a hustling Wayne Runnels.
A lot of good effort plays there. Caleb Korver, unbelievable offensive rebound, but falling out of bounds, has to just throw it up. It gets picked up by Hatch, and then Wayne Runnels does a really good job of sprinting back defensively and back tipping the ball away from Hatch, but now they'll set their defense, which will be a 2-3 zone.
Teray Murray gets it in to Demetric Williams. Jays up 36-31, 13-15 and counting second half. Murray leading all scorers with 14 points, driving hard down the left side. Runnels tried to take the screen. They tip it around and out of bounds. It'll go to the Blue Jays. Good defense that time.
Well, right now off the bench, Cavell Witter, Peon Stinnett combining for 16 of Creighton's 36 points, doing a really nice job of giving them a lift and boost offensively. See what they want to do here on this possession. Witter and Stinnett have been the story in the second half.
Two pretty good guys to bring off your bench.
Yeah.
Really. Two of your better scorers, if not your best.
Korver, high post, Reynolds, working on the seven-footer Stutz. Finds a cutting Stinnett, who lays it up and down. That's that backdoor cut again.
Again, yeah, you just said it there. Relieving pressure, good set play from Coach Altman. Has done a really nice job adjusting to some things Wichita State have been doing. Backdoor cut for Stinnett, bucket.
38-31, largest lead of the day for Creighton. Hatch on the far wing, looking inside Stutz. Nothing doing there. Back out to Metric Williams. Takes Cavell Witter down inside. Spin move, ball stripped away, but they're going to call a foul on a Blue Jay.
He's got Cavell Witter.
Yep, that's just his first personal, team's fourth, and they will say it was not in the act of shooting, so Williams will inbound. And now they say it is in the act of shooting. Williams didn't think it was. He was headed out of bounds. Williams on the season, 8 of 10. Averages about 11 minutes a game for Greg Marshall. And he misses that free throw. Wichita State is bit by the bug today as they are 7 for 13 from the free throw line. And it's the Blue Jays here this afternoon who are knocking down their throws at a clip of 75%, 15 for 20. 12:30 remaining in this second half. Jays up 38-31. Demetric Williams, the freshman at the line. Clevin Hanna on the bench as Williams, soft free throw, no good. Korver rebounds to that in front court, nowhere to go. Finds Witter between the circles. Smart play by P. Allen. Witter working on Demetric Williams, taking him to the near side wing. Down inside, stagger step. P. Allen's to that. Down inside, Lawson. Working on the seven-footer. Got to call a foul there, absolutely. Good move by Kenny Lawson.
Yeah, and Cavell Witter's changed this game at the point guard position. Coming in, really being active, putting pressure on the defense. It started with his penetration, kicked it out to Stinnett. Stinnett then, a little shot fake, makes Stutz have to help a little bit, feeds it down to Lawson. A strong move from Kenny on the block to draw the foul in the seven-footer Stutz. Cavell Witter's changed this game, though.
Third foul on Lawson. The reason he's changing, in my opinion, Nick, is because he's an offensive threat. Antoine Young in the first half was 0-for. Young 1-for-4, really no line at all, no assists, no nothing for Antoine. I mean, that's unlike him, but it's just not a good day for Antoine. Bad matchup. Witter comes in, more experience, boom.
Lawson knocked down the first throw there, and you said it there. Darren Antoine Young just shoot perimeter jump shots, helping way off him, and that's where
now Witter can take him up on that dare. And Cavell's got 7 points. And Lawson goes 2-for-2 that trip down. And the Blue Jays have the biggest lead of the day at 40-31. Now, this is a position Wichita State was not in at all last week, as Creighton never, ever threatened them. Now, Creighton is the one in the driver's seat at the 12-minute mark. Terre Murray gets the ball up in the front court on the high wing right side. Witter on him. Durley sets a screen. Murray top of the key. Back out Durley. Durley gets away with a walk. Over to Murray. High wing left side, Demetric Williams. Under 12 minutes remaining in the game. Williams takes Daryl Ashford for a screen, drives hard right. Bounce pass, Gabe Blair on the right block. Offensive foul, they got Gabe Blair for a little wraparound and elbow. Time out of the floor. 11:44 remaining second half. Jays will have the ball when we come back. They own a lead of 40-31 on Big Sports 590.
With new smart checking at American National and People's National Bank, you can earn up to 4.05 annual percentage yield on your account balance up to $25,000 every month. There's no monthly fee, no minimum balance, and qualifying is easy. Use your Visa check card to make 12 purchases. Set up one direct deposit, automatic debit, or bill pay from your account. Receive e-statements when available, so you have nothing to lose and a lot to gain. Go online at anbank.com or stop into any American National or People's National Bank to find out more. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Make this year your year to catch Arch Madness, celebrating 20 years of Valley basketball in St. Louis. Don't miss the 2010 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Men's Basketball Championship, March 4th through 7th at Scott Trade Center. Presented by Diet Pepsi and Fox Sports Midwest. Arch Madness. For tickets, call 314-241-1888. 314-241-1888. Or visit archmadness.com.
I finally did something about my big, fat energy bills. I picked up the phone and called 888-65-PELLA. Pella Window and Door Replacement made slimming my heating and cooling bills easy, even in this weather.
Capella professionals installed my new windows and doors for me and kept the inside of my home protected from the elements. Now, my bottom line looks better.
Request your free guide to window and door replacement by calling 888-65-PELLA. That's 888-657-3552. Pella, viewed to be the best.
Blue Jay basketball is brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there for all your insurance needs. Call Ron Niederhouse at 333-5104. And by the Crescent Moon Ale House, they're offering free shuttle service to and from Quest Center Omaha for all Blue Jay home games. And by Dex, take the sport out of finding information with Dex. Find what you need, when you need it, in print, online at dexknows.com.
11:44 remaining in this second half. Jays with their largest lead of the day, 40-31, after leading by just two at halftime. Nick, the boys have done what we've been looking for them to do for a while, and that is extend a lead, put a little more pressure on your opponent.
And yeah, they've done a really good job offensively of being the aggressor, dribble driving, posting up Kenny Lawson, and they've been much more efficient in this second half, first 8 minutes of this second half. And then defensively, they've done a nice job of switching things up between zone and man-to-man, and it's kept Wichita State out of sync and out of rhythm. And then Clevin Hanna picked up his third personal foul. It'll be interesting to see how long Greg Marshall wants to let his senior point guard sit on the bench.
This was the first conference game that the Shockers have trailed at halftime since their initial loss to Illinois State in conference play. They have led at halftime in every other game. So the only game they trailed at halftime, they lost to Illinois State. Lawson across the timeline fights off a couple of Shockers there to get rid of the ball for the Jays. They're in business. Cavell Witter working against Demetric Williams in front court. Witter off the bench has scored 7 points. He finds Korver, who finds Witter. It's Korver, Ashford, Witter, Harriman, and Lawson. Skip past Korver. Puts the ball on the floor. Drives inside. Shot up. Offensive foul, Caleb Korver. Ran right into JT Durley.
And there Wichita State went to a 3-2 zone, and Caleb Korver, a good shooter, decided to catch a shot fake, drive middle to his right hand. Durley was set. Caleb Korver tried to slide to his left to see if he could get it off the glass and avoid the contact. Doesn't get there in time. Caleb, offensive foul.
Caleb has really struggled this season.
And you can see Dane Allman put his arm around him, explain to him and say, bud, that's not your strength. I like the aggressiveness, but what you do is catch and shoot the basketball. But can't fault a guy for trying to make a play.
Nope.
And it was almost a three-point play.
40-31, Durley with the ball. Now top of the key. Now Hanna working on Ashford. Hard drive to the left, pump fake, got away with one. There's a deflected pass, intercepted by Carter. Great defense by the Jays. Carter up Witter. Cavell Witter on the wing to Carter, right side Ashford. Lawson working in there against Durley. Right side block, turnaround jumper is good. Kenny Lawson, and the Jays have opened a double-digit lead at 42-31.
Big-time move from a big-time player. Kenny Lawson face up, 12-foot jumper, nothing but splash from him.
On the move, down inside, Gabe Blair, pull up. Off the glass is good. Gabe Blair, soft touch. Kenny Lawson tying his shoe right in the middle of the action as Witter almost ran into him. 42-33, coming down to the midway point of the second half. Lawson is the outlet for Witter to get across the timeline. He gives it up. Harriman back Witter. Cavell working now against Teray Murray. High wing right side, Daryl Ashford. Hanna comes up on him. Hanna playing with three fouls. Near wing, Carter. Again, Wichita State out in the zone.
Yes.
Witter on the right wing. Top of the key, Carter. Left wing, Ashford. Lawson looking for the ball. Ashford loses it. Gets it back. Outlet. Three on the shot clock. Witter will rise up. Hand in his face. Off the iron, no good. Gabe Blair rebound. Gabe Blair stolen away by Justin Carter. And then Gabe Blair going for it. They will say it stays with the Blue Jays. They should have called a foul on Blair. But a great job of Carter of sneaking up on the Shockers.
Yeah, again, Carter's activity has been terrific. Stealing a possession there, but this 3-2 zone from Wichita State is very extended. The middle of this zone right around the free throw line is wide open. Creighton can't get on their heels. They got to find a way to penetrate, get into the teeth of this zone.
Carter inbounds Witter. Witter finds Stinnett back in the game. Near side wing to Carter again, looking for the lob. It wasn't there. Now Stinnett's on the wing. He is open. Pump fake. P. Allen moves one dribble to his right. Off the rim. No good. Graham Hatch with a rebound. Weak side. It's Wichita State. That was a good shot.
Yeah, it was.
Murray driving inside. Witter shuts the door there and then flies over a screen set by Gabe Blair. Now they find Blair with Harriman on him. Gabe Blair at 6'8 to Durley. Durley working on Lawson. JT Durley backing in. Lawson, there's a jump shot all the way. JT Durley. Kenny Lawson trading little fadeaway jumpers. 42-35. Jay's got to find a way to score here with 9:15 and counting. Second half. Hanna outlet again up into front court to Lawson. McKinney kicks it over to Spinett. P. Allen back to Witter. Left wing Carter.
Got to get to the middle of this zone, T-Scott, some way, somehow, whether it's via the pass or via the drive.
Lawson's going to try to set a screen. Now they go over there to Spinett. He kicks it back out. Witter, top of the key, three, off the back heel, no good. Rebound, Hannah. Jay's settling right there. They're not getting into the heart of that zone. Hatch, wing, three, off the rim, no good. Terry Murray jumping with Carter, and Harriman ends up with it. Pavel Witter pushing the ball. P. Allen Stinnett open on the wing. Three on the way. It's good. P. Allen Stinnett.
Well, that's one way to beat the zone. Beat it down the floor, baby. Pavel Witter, way to look ahead. Stinnett catch and shoot three right in front of Dana Altman. Bucket.
Crowd's got their little cardboard threes up. They haven't been able to swing them a lot. So the 4-3. Pavel Witter tipping that ball out of bounds. Jays, a lot of spring in their step right here at the 8-18 mark with a 45-35 lead.
And quietly,
back in the ballgame, Chad Miller, Antoine Young joining Stinnett, Carter, and Harriman for the Blue Jays.
And quietly, Stinnett all of a sudden with 14 points, doing a nice job in this second half of being really aggressive with the basketball. At half, Stinnett has 4 points. Yep. So he's got 10 points in the first 12 minutes of this second half.
8:17 and counting second half. Clement Hanna on the baseline to David Kiles. Jays up 10, 45-35. Over to Hanna. Wing, three on the way. In, out, no good. And that ball tipped around into the hands of Harriman again, who hustles for it. Casey finds Antoine Young back in the game. Antoine's got to be aggressive here, coming in off the bench. He's been on this bench a long time.
Yep.
Guarded by Clement Hanna. Young. Up and over to Chad Miller in off the bench as well. They've got to get into the floor of this game in a hurry. Stinnett guarded by David Kiles. Back out Carter between the circles. Hatch over the Millard screen. Justin Carter, top of the key. Millard decides against that three. Chad hasn't taken a lot of shots this year. Carter now driving on Graham Hatch. Door shut, bounce pass, Antoine Young. Dribble drive, down inside, fadeaway shot is good. Left hand, baseline right, Antoine Young answers.
Hello, Mr. Young, great move. Goes to his right, step back jumper on the baseline. Big shot from Antoine Young, who's been sitting on the bench.
Gabe Blair, right wing, kicks it back out. David Kiles, 7:15 and counting second half. Jays up, 47-35. David Kiles drives hard right. Kick out, outlet, Graham Hatch, three on the way. Hatch is good. Graham Hatch, a good three-point shooter at 45%. And on the afternoon, Hatch is 1-for-2. Antoine Young in a front court to Millard. Millard, far right wing, Carter. Double team. Carter has it knocked away by Hanna and loses it. My, my, Justin Carter a little weak with that ball. Clement Hanna driving inside. Ball is tipped out of bounds by P. Allen Stinnett. Time out of the floor. 6:48 remaining in this one, and it'll be Wichita State basketball when we come back. But the Jays on the lead, 47-38 on Big Sports 590.
In an auto accident, you're confused and don't know where to turn to fix your vehicle the right way. The Rusty Eck way. Rusty Eck is more than just your favorite Ford store. Rusty Eck is Nebraska's only Ford certified collision shop, the only one in Nebraska. No rental car? No problem. Rusty Eck will give you something to drive while they fix your ride free. You heard right, something free to drive while they handle all of your repairs. Rusty Eck certified technicians will thoroughly explain your estimate and then put your vehicle back together the right way. And you can feel good knowing that Rusty Eck uses eco-friendly products that are great for your car and safe for the environment. So no matter what make of vehicle you drive, if you need body work and you want it done the right way, the only way is the Rusty Eck way. Rusty Eck Auto Body, just off I-80 and Sapp Brothers exit. Auto Body done the right way, the only way, the Rusty Eck way.
Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear is your Blue Jay headquarters for both men's and women's Blue Jay gear. Year after year, the Blue Jay fans are a great benefit to our business. Jerry Ryan's at 78th and Dodge is where the Jays coaches shop for both Blue Jay gear and professional dress. We want to make things easy and fun for your professional dress needs. Exclusive sportswear and the best Blue Jay gear in town is waiting for you at Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear.
At Jerry Ryan's, we bring out the best.
Jay basketball is brought to you by California Taco. Help Brad Bogart and California Taco change Midtown one taco at a time. That's California Taco. And by Dr. Bimbo Petro. Doctors Bimbo and Vince Petro, General Family Dentistry on the corner of 144th and West Dodge Road. Dial 397-4505. And by American National Bank, where American dreams come true.
6:48 remaining in this one. Jay's up 47-38. You look at the second half stats, Nick. It is so deceiving because Creighton now is allowing Wichita State to shoot 43% from the field here in the second half. Jays 36%, but the Jays have hit three threes in this second half to extend this lead out to where it is right now at nine. It'll be Shocker basketball, though, with a lot of time left in this one.
Again, the story of this second half has been P. Allen Stinnett and Cavell Witter just changing the game with their athleticism and their ability to score the basketball. Again, between those two guys, 21 points off the bench. And right now, Creighton outscoring Wichita State's bench 27-5, and that's in large part due to those two young men.
Clevin Hanna will inbound for the Shockers, right side under the Shocker hoop. 6:48 remaining in the second half.
You gotta think Wichita State's not gonna go lightly here. They're gonna compete.
Oh, of course
they're gonna battle back here with 6:48.
Jay's gotta be real strong. Finish this game strong.
Well, the thing you want to see is you don't want to see them take their foot off the gas here and
try to milk the,
try to milk the clock,
yeah.
You know, play that prevent offense. They got to stay aggressive. A lot of game left.
Oh, boy. Clevenana looks to get it in. Durley working against Millard. He's got to trigger it into Kyle's out between the timeline top of the arc now. Right wing back Hanna. Hanna drives hard to his right, kicks out Kyle's baseline. He's open for a three, and it is no good, but a weak side rebound again in their number 32. That's Gabe Blair. Teray Murray now on the wing. Takes Cavell Witter to the right. Down inside is Durley. Shot on the way is good. JT Durley, tough shot over Chad Miller.
A fake baseline and spun to the middle. Shot a little hook shot with his right hand. That's a tough shot.
Witter working against Kyles. Goes to Carter on the wing. He just coughed it up. Now between the circles to Witter. High wing right side, Stinnett. Stinnett back Witter now near wing Carter. Working against a Shocker zone. Carter nowhere to go. Got to find somebody. There's Rogge in the ball game. He was open on the baseline. Jay's got to pop this ball around a little bit against his zone. They're getting hung up an awful lot. Not going anywhere with it. Carter, three on the shot clock. Tough shot. And goes down. Justin Carter. How he made that, I have no idea. From the right wing, it's a three. Count it.
Nothing doing. Justin Carter says, I'm a senior. Step aside, step back three right in front of Coach Altman. Drilled it. Big shot from Carter.
Lead back to 10, 50-40. Clevin Hanna at the top of the key. Working on Witter. Down inside. And they're going to call a foul on Cavell Witter. And how many is that on Cavell?
It's just two.
All right, Witter.
I tell you what, Clevin Hanna does a really good job of selling the foul. Every time he drives, any sort of contact, he really sells the fact that he got hit. And that's what happened right there. Not a whole lot of contact from Cavell Witter on Hanna there, but he sold the foul.
Kyle inbounds. Blair to Hanna. 5:25 and counting. Teray Murray, top of the key. Teray Murray drives inside, now kicks out Kyles on the baseline right. Carter on him, entry pass, kicked by Justin Carter. Shot clock at 22, 5:19 remaining second half. Jays up 10, 50-40 on Wichita State. Shockers come in at 5-1 in second place in the Missouri Valley Conference, 16-2 overall for the Shockers. Their only losses coming at Illinois State and at Pittsburgh. They kick it in. Clevin Hanna, top of the key, Witter on him. Witter might have got a piece of that. Oh, my! David Kyles, it was like a pass. It was an air ball that went right to Kyles directly under the bucket, and Kyles caught it and put it up and in.
Yeah, the toughest pass to toughest shot to rebound is an air ball.
And Cavell Witter just tried to fight off Clevin Hanna, and there's a shot up by Hanna as Witter was battling Hanna all the way up the floor, tried to get rid of the ball, and then found Chad Millard, who had it poked away by Teray Murray, and the Jays right there looked a little bit tentative, Nick.
Well, Cavell Witter got a little bit frustrated there. I think he tried to prove to Clevin Hanna, hey, you can't speed me up. I can bring the ball up the floor against you. Realized he couldn't do that, tried to throw it to a bounce pass to Chad Millard that got stolen, and then on the other end, Chad Millard has to foul Clevin Hanna as he's going in, and that's Chad Millard's fourth personal foul.
Second best free throw shooter in America, Clevin Hanna at 96% on the season. He is 2-for-2 today. And make it 3-for-3. And the lead is back to 7, 50-43. The Jays are really going to have to ratchet it up here, Nick, and respond, because Wichita State is going to get more and more physical.
Well, and really, they're going to have to find a way. I got to assume that Greg Marshall is going to make Creighton figure out something against this zone. Other than Justin Carter's step back three, Creighton hasn't really been successful against this zone.
And his second free throw out of his hands is good. He's the only one that's been good from the line today. Rogge looking at full court pressure. Sinet's got it. P. Allen works it up against Terrain Murray, and they almost steal it, and they do. They throw it away. P. Allen, Sinet. Jay's doing a lot of complaining about the physicality of Wichita State. They're not going to get any calls. They've got to just respond.
They got to do is, they were doing a good job earlier of flashing Kenny Lawson from behind right around the half court area, hitting the big guy, and then initiating, coming back up and getting the ball for him, initiating offense. Now they're trying to dribble through the press. It's not working.
Witter, Carter, Harriman, Stinnett. Hatch catches it in the paint. Hatch turns on Stinnett. Shot up. It's no good. Lawson jumped too early. It's knocked out of bounds, and it will be Blue Jay basketball. 4:35 remaining second half. Jays up 50-44.
But here comes this press. See what Creighton wants to do here. You got to, can't try and dribble through this full court press from Wichita State. They're too long. They're too athletic. They got to try and flash someone in from behind.
Ellis checks back in with three fouls. He replaces Gabe Blair. Harriman triggers it in to Witter. Clevin Hanna on Witter. Witter beats him up. There's a double team. Witter has the ball tied up, but they're going to call a reach in.
That's on Hanna. That's four.
Oh, my. And it is. And it is 10 team fouls on Wichita State, which means that the remaining 4:28 will have the Blue Jays going to the line for two free throws. Witter on the afternoon is 2 for 2. Jays as a team, 17 of 22.
Silly foul from Clevin Hanna right
there. Oh, absolutely.
And Clevin Hanna's going to, David Kyle's going to check in for him after these free throws from Witter.
And when Hanna has not been on the floor, the Shocker offense has really slowed down.
Yeah.
Witter so misses that free throw.
Number 24, David Kyle's checking in for Wichita State.
Kyle's in, Hanna out, Witter one more free throw.
So Creighton just trying to cling on to this 6-point lead.
But see,
here,
I'd rather not have them cling on to it. I mean, they've been, what got them here was aggressive play. Real aggressive play, and matching Shockers physically, blow for blow, as Witter knocks one of two down, that trip down. Don't hang on, put him away. 4:28 remaining, Jays up 7, 51-44. David Kyles with the ball at midcourt. Kyles over to Terrain Murray. He crosses the timeline. Murray on the left side. Now right side to Kyles, back Murray, sets up on the wing, top of the key catch. Hatch down inside. JT Durley faces up on Lawson. Left side outside the paint. Durley inside. Durley hook shot. Blocked by Carter, but he gets it back. Durley left block. Swings into Lawson. Jump shot. No good. Rebound. Kyles. Kyles lays it up and down. Oh my.
Kyles just wanted it more than every Jay on the floor there.
Kyles blocking foul. Cavell Witter going back to the free throw line. That was an incredible play by David Kyles. Timeout of the floor. 3:53 remaining in this one. Jays up 51-46. Cavell Witter going to the line when we come back on Big Sports 590.
Whether you want to cheer your team on, chow down, or chill, Barley's at 1510 Cumming is the answer. Just minutes from the Quest Center in the old Tip Top building, Barley's is the perfect location for your pre- or post-game get-together. And with three party rooms available, you can invite plenty of friends. Going to a Jays game or concert at the Quest, Barley's offers a free shuttle. So let's review. You want to cheer your team on, Barley's has TVs everywhere. You want to chow down, Barley's has a full menu. You want to chill, Barley's is a casual neighborhood bar. So give it a try. Barley's, 1510 Cumming in the Tip Top building.
I wanted to fly. They said I couldn't. So I built a plane, then a spaceship, then I went to the moon. I invented jazz, hip-hop, rock and roll. Some called it noise. I said it was music. I wrote a letter and sent it by ponies. It didn't get to you fast enough, so I used trucks and ships. But still, they weren't fast enough for me. So I lost the paper and the ink. I sent it by magic. I called it email. I made up new words. Jukebox, bling, Google. And I decided some old words weren't okay to say ever again. The mustache. I tried to bring that back 17 times. I wore knickerbockers and shoulder pads, poodle skirts and flannel. When I came back from World War II, all I had was a t-shirt. So I made that cool. In fact, I invented cool. Who am I? I'm the spirit of youth. It's my job to move the world forward. Pepsi. Every generation refreshes the world.
Blue Jay basketball is brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there for all your insurance needs. Call John Bergmeyer at 339-3555. And by Anthony's Steakhouse, Omaha's finest and friendliest restaurant. It's time now to take a look at our motto's three-point total. Jays are right now are 5 of 17 for Beyond the Arc. Good for 29% and 15 points. Jay's current three-point total is brought to you by Amato's Restaurant, old world flavor with new world taste.
3:53 remaining in the ball game. Jay's up 51-46, and they will be shooting free throws when we come out of this timeout. And the Blue Jays today, the difference in this game, Nick Baugh, because the Jays are getting outboarded 37-29, but their free throw shooting today has been a real key to having the lead and keeping the lead here this afternoon.
Yeah, really, for the most part, they've been mirror images of each other statistically right now. Both teams 5 of 17 from 3, but the difference has been their ability to get to the foul line when shots aren't going down and their ability to have bench point production with Cavell Witter and Pion Stinnett. Again, bench point discrepancy is just enormous, 28-9 in favor of the Jays. Stinnett and Witter doing a really nice job.
Witter goes to the line. Creighton. Witter knocks down that first one. The Jays, 18 of 24 so far in this game. 75% coming in. They were averaging 68%, dead last in the Valley.
Well, the situation they find themselves in now is what they, Coach Alvin's got to figure out what he wants to do defensively, if it's man-to-man or it's zone against Wichita State for this final 3:53.
Witter knocks them both down. On the floor, Cavell Witter, Casey Ehrman, Justin Carter, Kenny Lawson, and Pion Stinnett. Terry Murray, Clevin Hanna, Graham Hatch, JT Durley, Aaron Ellis on the floor for Greg Marshall and the Shockers. Murray and Hanna play catch across the timeline to get it over the Blue Jay pressure. Now Hanna's got it between the circles. Jay's up, 53-46. Need a stop right here. Hatch to Murray to Hanna. Shockers, 5 of 17 from downtown. There's a three. It is no good. Weak, not a Blue Jay in sight. Murray kicks it back out. Hanna, he'll try a three. Off the iron, no good. JT Durley, rebound, make it Aaron Ellis. And Lawson's got the ball. Aaron Ellis tried to put it back and couldn't. Wow.
They were like Neo there, dodging a bunch of bullets.
A matrix of that one went over the head of a lot of people except me. Like Neo. All right, Jay's up, 53-46. P. Allen Stinnett, a lot of dribbling, and they are going to call a foul as P. Allen Stinnett turns it over.
Just can't happen. Stinnett there just weak with the ball, gets it poked away from him, and then Clevin Hanna gets it, and then they foul.
The best free throw shooter in the country.
Yeah, and so he'll go to the line now, stopping the clock, chance to knock down two throws with the Jays up 7 right now.
53-46, Jays with the lead after dodging that bullet down there to come down and waste an opportunity like that. So Hanna steps the line. You can just about put this in the bank. He has missed two free throws all year long. Clevin Hanna. And I can't even jinx it. I can't even talk about
doing
it.
All you can.
Jinxing. Yeah. 46 of 48 coming in. He is 5 for 5 this afternoon. 3:01 remaining in this one. Possession arrow favors Wichita State. They've got 3 timeouts left. Jays with 4, so that's not an issue. And he makes them both. So he's perfect for the line, and the Jays are up 53-48. Harriman's got to get it in, does get it in Witter. Witter working it up against Clevin Hanna. They're trying to shut the door, finds Harriman. Calm down. Witter. And a whistle and a timeout called by Dana Altman.
Timeout.
Intelligent timeout.
Yes, absolutely. We're going to join him. 2:52 remaining in this game. Jays up 53-48. It'll be Blue Jay basketball when we come back on Big Sports 590.
Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear is your Blue Jay headquarters for both men's and women's Blue Jay gear. Year after year, the Blue Jay fans are a great benefit to our business. Jerry Ryan's at 78th and Dodge is where the Jays coaches shop for both Blue Jay gear and professional dress. We want to make things easy and fun for your professional dress needs. Exclusive sportswear and the best Blue Jay gear in town is waiting for you at Jerry Ryan Clothing and Sportswear.
Ryan's, we bring out the best in you.
Hi, I'm Sam Amato. My wife Ann and I had the pleasure of the Food Channel featuring our restaurant on Guy Fieri's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. On the show, we featured the blueberry ricotta pancakes, homemade Italian sausage, and the Sicilian steak sandwich. We invite you to come to our restaurant located on 64th and Center and try these delicious homemade meals. At Amato's, you can still put your elbows on the table and laugh out loud. Thank you.
extraordinary cuisine, exceptional service. That's what you get when you call the catering specialist at A Catered Affair. From spectacular box lunches to beautifully presented buffets, A Catered Affair will create an unforgettable event that you can be proud of. Whether you're entertaining a dinner party for 12 or planning a corporate event for 300, A Catered Affair is the answer. Call 614-5200. That's 614-5200. Extraordinary cuisine, exceptional service. That's what you get with A Catered Affair.
2:52 remaining here in the second half. Creighton up 53-48, led by two at halftime, has led by as many as 12 in the second half. But right now, we got ourselves a ball game, and the Jays are going to have to toughen up a little bit, Nick, and withstand the aggressive play of Wichita State, because in the past few series, it's been Wichita State that's been dominating physically Creighton with getting rebounds, getting putbacks, getting open look, getting to where they want to be. And Creighton has turned the ball over, I think, on three of the last four possessions, maybe.
Well, they're on their heels right now. This game's going to come down to how Creighton can handle the ball, knock down free throws, and if they can rebound the basketball.
Right now, they haven't done a very good job of that over the last few times. Now, Harriman will inbound near side backcourt. Jays have got to get it open. They get open to Witter. Witter guarded by Terre Murray. Cavell on the move. Cavell coming up at the timeline. Looking to the center of the floor. They find Lawson. He's the outlet. Kenny hands off Cavell. Near the timeline. They've got it into offensive zone now. Now Witter guarded by Terre Murray's hands all over him. Witter, double team, clears it over to Stinnett on the wing. Harriman catches, back out Stinnett. Three on the shot clock. Stinnett on the move. Two, P. Allen throws up a wild shot off the side of the backboard. Not a good possession, and here comes Murray. Driving outside, wing to Hatch. Top of the key, Durley. He's gonna take a three and knock it down. J.T. Durley. 42% on the season, that's no aberration. We got a two-point game. Jays not reacting well at all to the aggressiveness of Wichita State and back on their heels. Cavell Witter at the free throw line. Back out Carter to Witter. Got to take it right at him. Man-to-man defense. Nope, make it that zone. Witter top of the key, a lot of dribbling. Jump shot off the glass, no good. Lawson off the glass, the putback is good.
Cleaned up Cavell Witter's mess of a shot. Shot didn't even draw iron, but Lawson there for the rebound putback on the weak side.
Jays got to have a stop right here. 1:35 and counting to Ray Murray. Timeout Greg Marshall. That putback gives Jays a 55-51 lead after the Jays really struggling offensively and defensively.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Creighton at one point was up 50-40, so a 11-5 run here for Wichita State in the last handful of minutes. And that's a good timeout for Greg Marshall to try and get Clevin Hanna back into the basketball game so they can be efficient offensively. Now, Dane Altman's got to make a decision, as I've said a couple minutes ago, on what he wants to do, zone or man-to-man. The problem is right now when they're going zone, they're struggling to rebound the ball. So I'd maybe look for Coach Altman to come out, try a man-to-man possession here, and if the ball goes into JT Durley or Gabe Blair, be there for the double team, make them make another play.
Five different Shockers now have knocked down threes after Durley knocked that one down. I mean, you've got Durley and Stutz. Now, Durley, he shoots 42% from downtown, but Garrett Stutz earlier took a three. They're seven-footer. All right, here we go. It will be Shocker basketball, 27 on the shot clock, 1:35 remaining second half. Hatch inbounds to Ray Murray. Jays up 55-51. Murray, high wing left side, Hanna. He'll center it up, right wing, Murray. Looking into Durley. Bayham's double team. Dribbles out of it. Durley kicks it out. Intercepted by P. Allen. Stinnett. Stinnett one-on-one with Hanna. We'll pull it back out. Smartly done. Witter with 1:17. Witter guarded by Hanna. Moves a couple steps over. Hanna up on him. Senior on senior. Two possession lead for Creighton. Carter denied by Hatch. Cavell Witter near the timeline with 15 on the shot clock. Coming down to the one-minute mark. Witter,
1 minute.
Up on the wing. Witter, down inside. Witter, shot off the glass, no good. Lawson tries for the putback. He's fouled, and he'll shoot free throws.
It's a terrific offensive rebound. Casey Harriman grabbing the jersey at Kenny Lawson, saying, attaboy, big dog. Way to follow the play. Cavell Witter with a high ball screen from Lawson. Drives into all the way to the basket, misses the layup of Lawson. Rebound put back, and in the act of trying to stick it back, it gets fouled. Two throws for Lawson now.
And that's the second time in a row that Kenny's bailed his buddy Cavell Witter out, yeah. And Lawson misses the free throw.
54 seconds left. Jays up 55-51. Lawson's going to step back to the line. One of the best free throw shooters on the team. Lawson at 79% makes that one. So one for two. Now's when the Jays will have to hit their throws. Up five. Got to get a stop right here. Crowd heating up. Turay Murray from Hannah into front court, left wing. Between the circles, the hatch. One dribble to Murray, driving inside. Murray's shot is good. Oh, my, what are they going to call there? Turay Murray got that ball to go down, hung it on the rim, but I guess they'll say he did it to protect himself, and he makes the jam going baseline. That was a heck of an athletic shot right there. Lawson went for the block, and Murray went right through it. 56-53, 41.6 seconds. Shockers did not take long right there to score, Nick.
No, they were. Creighton went with that matchup zone where a touch late getting to Murray, gave Murray an angle to drive baseline. As you said, that's an unbelievable finish over Lawson and over Carter right at the rim. And now Dane Altman in a timeout. He's going to tell the players what they want to do offensively when they break the pressure. But the most important thing he's got to draw up right now is the press break, which has given Creighton problems all afternoon. See what they want to do against this kind of box pressure from Wichita State, who they love to trap right around the half-court line. So got to find a way to break this pressure and then be strong with the basketball.
Jays with the lead, though, 56-53, 41.6 seconds. Harriman's going to inbound, and Aaron Ellis at 6'9 will be on Harriman. Tough to see through, over, and around him. Lawson is in there. Carter, Witter, and Stinnett.
Casey can run the baseline.
Murray,
it's a made basket.
Hannah, Hatch, Durley, and Ellis for the Shockers. Harriman can run the baseline, as you just said. He's got the ball. He's got to get it in. He finds Stinnett. Stinnett is double teamed. Stinnett trying to dribble through it. He is trapped on the inline and throws it away off of a Shocker. So now the Jays will do it again. Far side backcourt. 36 seconds.
Jay's got three timeouts. Got to keep that in mind right now with only six.
Shockers with just one timeout. Harriman to inbound. Far side backcourt. Get it in Lawson. Kenny's got it. Over to Witter. Through a double team. They get away with them. Now Witter. Ball knocked away from behind. Into the hands of Justin Carter. They get a timeout called. Absolutely. Cavell Witter lost that ball. Again, if you're a Blue Jay fan, you're looking for a foul as Wichita State got away with one grab, another grab, and another grab, but Justin Carter out-hustles the Shockers to get the ball and the timeout, and Greg Marshall is giving the officials an earful. And I'm not sure what he has to complain about.
He maybe felt like Justin Carter maybe fouled on his dive.
That was after his guys fouled the Blue Jays in backcourt and in frontcourt.
That is a difference-making toughness play from Justin Carter, realizing that Cavell Witter got the ball knocked away from him. He's on the ground. Ball is loose. The game is on the line. Carter gives up his body, dives on the floor,
tears it away from, I think it was Murray, who went to the floor with him. Carter tears it away, secures it enough to call a timeout. And during that whole thing, about 6 or 7 seconds went off the clock.
Yeah, really nice job from Justin Carter to bail out Cavell Witter, who tried to dribble through the pressure, and Clevin Hannah was trailing him and knocked it off his leg and created a scramble situation, and Carter was right on the ball, did a really good job of stealing the possession back for Creighton. Now with 26 seconds on the game clock, 20 on the shot clock, with the Jays up three, got to get the ball inbounds. That's order number one, and we'll see what Greg Marshall wants to do.
Exactly.
If he wants to defend this possession out, or if he wants to foul and extend the game.
Lawson, Carter, Harriman, Witter, and Stinnett answer the bell for Dana Altman.
Again, two
Murray,
timeouts
Durley,
left.
Murray, Durley, Ellis, Hatch, and Hannah for Greg Marshall and Wichita State. 26.5 left in this one. Jay's already up. 56-53. Harriman to inbound. Gets it in Justin Carter. Guarded by Graham Hatch. Carter fouled immediately. So Justin Carter, one of the worst free throw shooters percentage-wise on the year, but today one of the best at 4-for-6. Now it's crunch time. Double bonus, so the Jays don't have to worry about that. They've got two shots every time they go to the line. Right now, they'll have to win this game from the line. That is the decision that Greg Marshall has made.
I think that's a probably good decision by Greg Marshall.
And Carter in the game misses that free throw.
So here we go. They're bringing in some bigs here. Durley and Stutz coming back in the game to grab this rebound for Wichita State. Got to make sure you get back if you're Creighton. Set your defense and got to communicate all screens.
Antoine Young in the game for the Blue Jays now.
Offense, defense.
Then head out.
Carter was 4 for 6.
Makes the second. So
big
it
shot.
Is a two-possession lead. Oh, my, that was big, Nick.
57-53, 22 seconds. Jays need a defense right here. Hannah to Hatch between the circles with 17. Hannah right wing. Winner stays on the ground. Hannah through the screens. Three on the way is good. Clevin Hannah, it's a one-point ball game. 13 seconds left. 57-56, Jays. Another timeout called. And another defensive mistake there. That one from Cavell Witter to go under the ball screen from Hannah. Gotta understand, he was shot hunting for a three. You gotta go over all screens with Hannah. He goes under the screen. Hannah stops right behind it, able to tee up a three, and he drills it to cut the lead to one with 13 seconds left. Those are the type of assignments you can't afford to not stay in tune with. Gotta know who you can go over and who you can go under ball screens with and who you can't. And Hannah makes him pay. And now
Hannah with his first three of the afternoon. He is 1 for 6 from downtown. And what a big time for the senior point guard to knock it down for Wichita State. But the Jays are still in the driver's seat. They are up 57-56 with 13.1 seconds left in this game. Obviously, they've got to get the ball in and be strong with it. Wichita State will pull at it. They'll grab at it. They're going to try to knock it away until they hear the whistle blow. And then, of course, the Jays have got to hit their free throws.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see if Greg Marshall wants to foul right away or if he'll maybe let one trap be set, see if Creighton will cough it up, because they've shown them to be susceptible to turning it over with this full court pressure. They only got 9 turnovers for the game, but six of them have been in the second half.
I think with 13 seconds left, you foul right away, because you know that if the Jays go to the line, and even if they hit two, it's still a one-possession game, and you want as much time as you got to get that next shot off.
And if that's the case, you have to make sure this basketball goes in to either Cavell Witter or Kenny Lawson.
Those would be
best
your
free
two
throw
preferences.
Shooters.
Pialis to net's not bad either at crunch time. So Harriman looks at Aaron Ellis, all 6'9 of him. Jays all back up near the midcourt line as they wait to come flying down to be receivers for this basketball. Harriman looking, gets it in Stinnett. Stinnett gets around Hatch. Stinnett has the ball deflected out of bounds. 9 seconds left, and it will stay with the Jays. Oh, mama.
So Greg Marshall elected to set a trap.
He did.
Stinnett dribbles out of it, but now they're going to face guard on the sideline and foul right away.
Harriman to inbound, under 10 left. Gets it in Stinnett. Stinnett on the dribble. P. Allen with 6, with 5, loses the ball and doesn't get called for double dribble. Gets it up to Winter with 2, with 1. Unbelievable as the game is over and the Jays win 57-56. Oh, my. Nick Baugh, you have a confused look on your face.
You've got to be absolutely kidding me that with 13 seconds left, Greg Marshall never fouls
anybody.
I saw him yelling at his team to foul. He was giving them civil shirt and screaming foul, but they don't do it. Unbelievable that they let the clock run out.
Absolutely. P. Allen Stinnett got the ball on the inbound in backcourt and dribbled around and actually lost the ball for a minute and got it back himself, and it could have very easily been called because it didn't look like he got poked out. He just lost it. And then he got it and fired it to Winter, and they still didn't go get him. All right, we'll take it. 57-56. Jays win and defend home court here. They defeat Southern Illinois and Wichita State, two of the top-tier teams. And we'll come back with a U.S. Bank postgame show after this on Big Sports 590.
Adoramus Books, Omaha's largest Catholic bookstore, featuring Catholic gifts, books, movies, and music. With over 18,000 items in stock, Adoramus Books has what you need for the Lenten and Easter season, as well as a wide selection of First Communion and Confirmation gifts. Adoramus Books is located on 84th Street, south of Center in the Frederick Square Shopping Center. Open late Thursdays till 7 and Saturdays till 4. Adoramus Books, resources for your Catholic home. The Creighton Athletic Department and its commitment to excellence is proud to be associated with the new full-service Holiday Inn downtown Omaha at 15th and Cumming Streets, a hotel dedicated to setting the standard in service with a focus on the business traveler. With its gallery-like lobby and spacious king and double king rooms, the Holiday Inn downtown Omaha will quickly become your business base camp in Omaha. For more information on rates and availability, call 402-341-0124 or go to holidayinndowntownomaha.com.
Stay on top of your game with the primary care physicians and specialists of Creighton Medical Associates.
They'll give it all they've got to ensure the finest medical care for you and your family, from newborns to senior citizens. Stick with the winning team of Creighton Medical Associates, because good health is the right play of the game. Visit www.findyourphysician for a Creighton Medical Associates physician right for you and your family. Whether you want to cheer your team on, chow down, or chill, Barley's at 1510 Cumming is the answer. Just minutes from the Quest Center in the old Tip Top building, Barley's is the perfect location for your pre- or post-game get-together. And with three party rooms available, you can invite plenty of friends. Going to a Jays game or concert at the Quest, Barley's offers a free shuttle. So let's review. You want to cheer your team on, Barley's has TVs everywhere. You want to chow down, Barley's has a full menu. You want to chill, Barley's is a casual neighborhood bar. So give it a try. Barley's, 1510 Cumming in the Tip Top building. Creighton Athletics would like to thank the following Wheels Club sponsors for their support. Hatchley Ford, Beardmore Chevrolet, Gateway Collision Center, Gene Steffi Chrysler Jeep Dodge, Markle BMW Land Rover Jaguar Mini, O'Daniel Honda, Performance Toyota, Rusty at Ford, and Omaha Mitsubishi and Infinity of Omaha. The Creighton Athletics Wheels Club. You help keep the Blue Jays rolling.
You've been thinking about going to for quite a while now. Or maybe getting that new or get a tan in. A competitive U.S. Bank home equity line of credit gives you the freedom to do, go, or get whatever you've been dreaming of. Home equity rates are lower than they have been in years. Apply today at any convenient U.S. Bank branch, at usbank.com, or call 888-444-BANK. U.S. Bank, five-star service guaranteed. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Welcome to the U.S. Bank postgame show. The Blue Jays, winners of two in a row now here at home. 57-56 winners on just a wild finish, Nick Baugh. And again, you could shake your head for a lot of different reasons here at that finish. But the bottom line is the Blue Jays, from the free throw line today, did what they had to do to win this basketball game, and they come away with a one-point win.
Well, they did that. They did what they had to do aggressive in terms of aggression offensively.
Yep.
For the first 12 minutes of that second half, that really extended that lead to about 10 or 12.
Yep,
there.
12.
They're up 12 with 7.5 to go in the second half.
And so you knew the Shockers would make a run, and they did.
Yeah, but hats off to the Blue Jays. They did what they had to do to win this game. But again, I'm in utter and complete disbelief how you allow 13 seconds on the game clock to run off and never foul.
And I honestly believe, though, that they were trying to foul. Because Stinnett was getting mugged, but they didn't blow the whistle. And then Winter, as he was coming down into front court and coming this way, was also, they were pawing at him. But I guess they didn't.
You got to make it obvious.
Exactly.
David Kyle's allowed. First of all, when Pion Sinnett caught, David Kyle's caught the ball. Kyle's allowed way too much separation initially, but then he tried to close the gap, and Sinnett lost the ball.
I don't know. Here, hold on. Down there, so we can hear it.
Golly,
yeah, we're standing.
I need to
sit.
We're giving. Oh, I don't care.
Talk about this ball game. % from downtown.